nights I chose this music over the D-game. Don't have as much bread, but I'm free, man. I'm migrating places that ICE couldn't detain. A hood-ass nigga is just another refugee name. Have I done enough? Cause I done done everything. I'm an overthinker, maybe cause I got like three brains. My gut and my nuts and my mind that I reclaim. Too many of us running out of minutes like we prepaid. Yeah. You know I gotta talk my shit. Haven't I given my all? Yeah, hell. Yeah. No need to extend.
Welcome to the On Mute podcast.
She sounds so good.
One day I'm gonna get an ass up here to do it correctly instead of a voice on my phone. But welcome. That's that crowd. Welcome to the On Mute motherfucking podcast, man. How y'all doing tonight, people?
Man, we good.
God damn, what was that? Bro.
You like the nigga with the baby Henny bottle right now?
Cut the camera off.
Frog in the throat ass nigga.
To my motherfucking left,
it's your boy Corey, aka Jukum Jones, aka Corey Mo, Mr. 9700, A-Leaf All Star. Dang, I can't say the mayor of Champa Bay no more.
Thank God.
Oh man, thank goodness though.
Dang, Polo Jones, man. What's up? Who I got to my left?
Man, you already know it's Tubbs, aka I'm trying to lay on my back and see my dick at the same time. aka I'm about to work out. You know what I'm saying? AKA, we going to the gym. AKA, every day is arm day. AKA. AKA, we going to get to these legs later. Every day, all chest, no legs. Shit, man, who I got to my left, bro?
Man, it's your boy King Dashe back in the motherfucking building.
Welcome back, man.
And this is your boy DJ, Mr. On Mute, the opinionated asshole. Young Aegon Targaryen in the flesh, Detroit Red reincarnated. Mr. Fuck you if you don't like my opinions. And we got a guest in the motherfucking building tonight. We got to have guests on guests on guests on guests in this motherfucking now. Y'all better get used to it. Yo. But tonight, we got Rob motherfucking Gillette. How you doing, bruh?
Yes, sir. Mr. Number One album of, what was it?
That was 2021.
2021, yeah. Number one album, 2021.
The leader of the Gillette.
Yeah.
The Gillette,
Gillette Mafia family.
Yeah. GMF, you know what I'm saying?
9700, Hall of Famer.
Y'all already know, big polo player, man.
Yeah.
What I got, Rob Gillette, a.k.a.
Did you wear polo tonight on purpose? You wear polo tonight on purpose?
A.k.a. El Grande.
Yeah,
a.k.a. Critical. 2Ks, no C's, all that, man. Yeah.
AKA Sir Rice a lot.
Hey, you know Rice man.
Yeah, that's him.
Yeah. We in here, man.
How you doing tonight, brother?
Man, I wish I was here under better circumstances.
Understood.
But, you know, I'm outside of that, everything is everything. You know what I'm saying? I can't complain about nothing other than just that current circumstance, man.
For sure, like, bro. For sure.
I hate it's happening, but.
Yeah.
You know, just want to say, man, I hate to even be saying this, man, but rest in peace to my brother Daniel Brown, a.k.a. Nope. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Love you.
Quick moment of silence for my man, though.
Straight up.
All right, for sure.
Facts, man. So,
he was known. Like, yeah. I didn't know him personally, but I seen him a few times, though, around the city.
Bro had love, man. It's like,
yeah.
It's just... That shit just, for this to be happening, man, it kind of feels surreal.
For sure.
But at the same time, it's like, I kind of wanted to, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I know, bro, you feel me? So.
Nah, that shit definitely hit different when you actually know the motherfucker.
Yeah, it's
you know
like, this not like no music partner, man.
Yeah,
we do music together, obviously, you feel me? But we went to high school together, you know what I'm saying? That's my day-to-day partner, man. Like,
for sure.
We don't see each other. We talk every day, every other day, you know what I'm saying?
For
this to be happening, it's just, you know.
Crazy, bro. So, no update, same thing as it was the other day?
Well, I mean, unfortunately, you know, it's the dude.
He turned himself in.
He turned himself in and shit, man. Yeah. But he ain't letting us know where my bro is.
For sure.
At least we got that confirmed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At least you know who did it. So it's justice in some sort of way.
Yeah.
Knowing how the court system worked through my sister, I know what this is.
Nah,
but
fuck the court system. Know how the hood work.
Well, no, knowing why he hasn't said everything he has to say yet. Okay, I know how this goes. My sister explained it to me. Mm-hmm. It's bullshit, but That's just the fucking world we fucking live in.
I ain't gonna lie. One of y'all niggas coming missing. Oh, it's a wrap. I'm going full Rambo.
Yes.
That's the way it's supposed to be.
Anybody I fuck with, full Rambo.
It took a lot out of us not to, you feel me?
Nah, for sure.
I'm gonna say that, man. Like, you know, like.
Yeah, we're not going to elaborate. It took a lot of us not to. For sure.
You say that.
For sure.
And, you know, being that was your homie, we know he was proud of you, and you know he damn sure was proud of this album. So we can get into Corner Store Legend.
Oh, yeah.
Corey Moe, you want to start, even though, you know, we already ranked the man number one last year. We never gave a full review on the project.
Nah, man, I start.
Go ahead.
I mean, brace yourself. You know, nah.
When Tubbs wants to start.
Yeah. I'm not going to stop this shit.
Nah, I fuck with Gillette. I do. Last time we
Gillette, you sure?
Gillette was supposed, like shut up. Last time Gillette was supposed to be on the show, he didn't show up, but we ain't going to talk about
man.
That. Now, we ain't going to talk about
I
that.
I got life issues.
And he ain't got no rights with him. So we ain't going to talk about that either. You know what I'm saying? That's my nigga, though. He's still my nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to disagree with what the consensus was on the first album, but I mean, on the number one album. I mean, it's well deserved. I ain't gonna lie to you, my nigga. I listened to the episode and I was like, okay, yeah, they got a point.
I was surprised. I ain't gonna front.
Nah, don't be surprised. Cold, nigga.
It's not that. Yeah. It's just like, you know, the names that it was over, you feel me? Like,
for sure.
So that was surprising. But in the sense of like the city or whatnot, like, I mean, you know, it is what it is, man. Right. But just in that, I was thankful because I like to think I can compete on that level, you feel me? Yeah. Like, I don't think that I'm just...
Shit, you an OG in the game.
Yeah, so it's... I've been doing it at a high level for a long time, but this album was different in the sense that, like, a nigga wasn't, like, going through, like, that struggle that I had been going through, you know what I'm saying? It's not like I'm just balling or nothing, but...
Right, but it seemed like you was in a better place, though.
Nah, mentally, nah, nigga was in a much better space, you feel me? Like, Tortoise Theory was... Man, that was a hell of a just going, like, man, nigga was homeless and sick and just a lot of shit, you feel me? Right. So to be able to get up out that hole and to be able to just still have an opportunity to make music,
right.
It was like, all right, I just wanted to make an album, man, that I guess was fun.
Yeah.
Like, in my sense of fun, my shit always gonna be kind of serious.
Right.
But, like, I didn't want to make another Tortoise Theory.
Niggas can groove to it a little bit more.
Yeah, it's easier to listen to. Yeah, you feel me? But the raps is harder, though. Yeah. You feel me? The raps is way harder. So it was just like, find the right beats. I had this notion that I wanted to have like a trappy sound, you feel me, in terms of the drums.
Right.
But like with my rap style, that shit just worked well. Yeah. So, I mean, shit happened. And shout out Derrick Rhodes. You feel me? He, like, we worked. You know what I'm saying? He heard the vision and made everything sound right. Shout out RJ and Chavez.
For sure.
Over at Wormhole for just, you know what I'm saying, everything they did in terms of helping me get it put together.
Yeah.
And shit, there we go. It just worked.
Yeah, for sure.
It just
for
worked.
For sure. I you good with me, buddy.
Man, it's all good, man. Like,
you'd be better if I had my rights.
Man.
But you good with me now.
Should I bring rights, man? I see where y'all at. It just today was a...
Yeah, understand.
I'll pay for the rice.
Yeah, it ain't even that.
I mean, the shit look good though. Like when you gave it to the Mexicans and the Mexican fuck with, I was like, that ain't got something serious.
That shit, the music is like, all right, I've been doing this. Right. Nigga, I expect a certain level of like, you know what I'm saying, that's gonna come with it. So the rice, that's still like,
that shit's crazy because
I don't got no history of working in food, my nigga. My first job was that Denny's on Westheimer.
Yeah.
But other than that, I ain't never worked in the food industry. Like, I don't cook for people other than my kids.
Yeah.
It was just one of them things that, like, I be telling niggas the truth of the matter is, nigga, I was living out of vacant apartments. You feel me? Over there in Maryland. It was a lot going on, but they got lights and power. They all bills paid, nigga. So I'm... In the pandemic, I got a lot of food stamps.
Yeah.
I got these little homies. They 15, 16, 17. They mom and basically abandoned them.
Yeah.
So they staying in the Vaco. So I would be cooking and I would give them food and shit. Yeah. And then one day I wanted some fried rice, but the spot was closed. I'm like, fuck it. I think I could make it. I had tried to make it before. I went online to see where I went wrong.
Yeah.
And you got to like cook. You got to use like a day old rice basically.
Okay.
You can't fry like right as soon as you fry.
Yeah, right.
So there's a cheat code.
Damn. Damn.
So I went and got like that ready rice.
Yeah.
Feel me?
Yeah.
I ain't have time to cook it, but I went and got the ready rice.
Yeah.
I made it. Wasn't thinking nothing of it. I gave it to the little homies.
Yeah.
It was like, man, bro, this shit good. I'm like, all right, so I'm making it some mold in this little chick I was dealing with.
Yeah.
I would bring her food. And one day she paid me for it. She was like, man, I can't.
I'm like, damn.
And she was like,
yeah,
bro, you need to do something with this. So I'm like, all right. And again.
Sure enough, yeah.
I remember I told Note, I went to his house. This was July 2020, like my birthday, I believe.
Yeah.
July 19th. And I'm like, man, I got this fried rice, man. Like, and nigga kind of looking at me like, nigga, what the fuck you on now?
Yeah.
I was like, bro, it's like soul food and fried rice mix.
Yeah,
I'm going to call it soul fried rice.
Yeah.
That nigga was one of the first people that was like, man, do that shit. You feel me? Do it.
Yeah.
I was in Maryland. I started walking around, man, like it was hard or something. You feel me?
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
hey,
yeah.
I got this rice.
Yeah.
Niggas was coming to my little Vacos, man. Laws had ran up in one of the spots thinking I was trapping out that bitch.
Damn. It's just fried rice. It's fried.
Law ended up buying some rice from me. Feel me? Yeah, real deal.
That's what's up.
So it's like, after that, I ended up leaving there because it got kind of hot.
Yeah.
Come back in like April.
Yeah.
2021.
Yeah.
And I was down bad again, but I'm like, man, I'm not finna be in this hole. You feel me?
Yeah,
so
yeah, yeah.
Got up out the hole. And one day, nigga, I was like, man, I'm gonna change my prices.
Yeah.
I say, I'm gonna do a $30 pan Juneteenth. And from Juneteenth, 2021,
take off.
That shit just went up.
Shit, you thinking about doing like a food truck type shit?
Yeah. I'm more so in line with like a kitchen.
Okay.
A restaurant, okay. Like a
brick and mortar.
Like a Frenchie's in the Clark type situation, a smaller.
Sure.
The food truck thing, man, it's like, I'm kind of claustrophobic, number one.
I got you. Yeah.
I don't know if I want to be in no food truck in hot ass Houston all day.
10, 12
especially
hours.
In summer, nigga. So, especially in summer. Yeah.
It's one of them things where I'm kind of learning. It grew fast,
right.
Then I had to realize, whoa, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Like,
it's more than just making rice.
Yeah, nah, I'm learning portions. I'm learning how to present it properly. And,
but that's where you get you a team, though.
Well, I mean, it's
together. Yeah.
Shout out Kalima. You feel me?
Yeah,
that's my team, man.
Yeah,
Kalima.
Okay.
Straight up and down. And like other people, like I got certain friends that's in the food world that allow me to pick their brain.
Soda.
And shit, nigga, I just been running with it, man. YouTube University.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? Learning how to properly prepare the rice. I try to cook it.
That's how I cook.
Yeah.
YouTube
like,
and Google.
YouTube, man. I got woks, man. I know how to.
But
I
got woks now.
Yeah, nah.
Oh,
nigga been doing it, man. So
Panda Express.
Nah, it's better than that, man.
Yeah, for sure.
It's better than that, man.
Nah,
so,
that shit good at a bitch.
We upgrade, like that video I did, that nine on my waistline.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
I'm really in front of Timmy Chan's, like, man, fuck y'all, nigga. Like, I got the best rice, nigga.
Yeah,
so
right.
I feel like, nigga, I'm going to come really for the hood. You feel me? Niggas ain't eating lamb chop in the ghetto. You feel me? Niggas not eating certain type of foods in the ghetto. So I'm going to provide a certain level of quality of food that niggas ain't used to getting.
There you go.
And then I'll be trapping with the late night trappers, too, man.
Mm-hmm.
Niggas is up late.
Shit, I know a lot of niggas that, I know a couple of people. Like around that 1:30, 2 a.m. leaving the club type shit. Yeah, niggas make money.
They be hungry, man. So I'm like, shit. Now, like,
I definitely be hungry.
When I'm in my spot, I'm on West Belford and 400, nigga. You motherfucker think I'm selling dope or something, my nigga.
Yeah.
I'm literally all night, man. Fridays and Saturdays, niggas getting out the club 2-3.
Yep.
Man, come pull up, nigga. Like you see what my spot is. You feel me? Come pull up, nigga. I ain't tripping.
Shit, it was three
better.
Motherfuckers there when I pulled up. Like, my ride.
It's better than being in that Whataburger line.
They was really coming.
That's way better than Whataburger.
Oh yeah, cause and once I learned how to like make it like proper, like at first I was literally like, when you order, I make it. When you order, I make it.
Yeah.
I didn't know how to store food.
Mm-hmm.
None of that shit. You feel me? I just kind of had this idea.
Just whipping that shit up.
And I'm like, why ain't no nigga ever made fried rice like that? Now, St. Louis, if any of y'all been to St. Louis.
My brother-in-law from there, that nigga talk about that shit like it's steak and shrimp.
Yeah, they fried rice is, I guess, similar in the sense that it's seasoned a little more.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But like, I'm like, man, I'm watching how the Asians cook food.
Yeah,
they cook like soul food. It's very similar. You know what I'm saying? So
right.
I just took a lot of their concepts and put it in our concepts. Like, I got some man, I got some shit, man, that's about to start coming in terms of, like, the side menu, and I'm expanding the menu.
That's what's up.
My son.
Then you add gravies in your rice?
Man, I got, like,
added gravy.
I got some shit, bro. I got, like, a barbecue gravy sauce I be making.
Yeah,
like,
I seen that.
And then, like, this crawfish and shrimp etouffee, that's really what's been winning recently.
Damn.
And it really ain't even no etouffee. That's the closest thing to it, man. Yeah, it's right. Like a sauce I made. And my son, son, that nigga, he be coming with ideas.
Well, shit, now you can start a partnership with, black-owned. Like, I know a black-owned business that have a spice business.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Adeola Spice. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You can definitely...
Nah, that's what I'm looking into, man.
Yeah, for sure.
And really, my next mission, man, is this frozen food section. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, I've been studying that, how to get into that. I got some relationships with the people at Pyburn, so once I can able to get a packaging, you feel me? It's kind of like one of them things.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to hit these corner stores with them and shit, you feel me?
Boys bringing shrimp fried rice to Thanksgiving dinners besides regular fried rice.
Nah, I mean, and it's...
Besides dirty rice.
It's way more than just shrimp fried rice, though. You feel me? I got the shrimp. I do the fried chicken. You know what I'm saying? I got different sausages. I be throwing lamb chops. I tried red beans and rice the other day. It didn't work all the way, so I got to...
You got to tweak it.
I got to tweak it a little bit. I'm just trying different things, man. For it's sure. very To me, it's very similar to making music, though, in terms of the creative process, like the fulfillment I get.
Right.
It feel like performing almost. Right, you know what I'm saying? Right. So it's...
Shit, you try something new. All right, let me tweak that. You know what I'm saying? Come back, do something else. Yeah, for sure.
And now it's like, shit, if a nigga want to book me, nigga, you can't pay me. Let me sell some rice at that hoe.
Exactly.
It's my business. I'm going to get some money somehow. Yeah.
You feel me? Yeah, and we can still rep. Man,
for sure.
Trying to take over that shit because there's some people that be cooking and rapping, man, but... Ain't nobody that rap as good as me to be cooking.
For sure.
They lacking somewhere.
They lacking, nigga.
Yeah.
And I ain't out here selling fish plates, man. So it just worked out.
Yeah.
Corey Mo, what you had on the project, bro?
Oh, shit.
Forgot what we was talking about.
Yeah, man. We talked about it.
Everything always come back around to the music.
Man, the 4-5, bro. Straight up. It was well thought out. I was waiting on it from the first time I heard you say Cornerstone Legend coming. Like, what the fuck is this nigga talking about? This nigga start going to corner stores, rating them hoes. And I'm like, okay, this nigga here got some shit coming down. And it was live, bro. It definitely lit up to my expectation of what I expect from a project from you, bro. Like you said, it was a little something on there for everybody. It was you, but it was like a different level.
Yeah, nah, like, a lot of times, this why I be fighting against the term lyricist, you feel me? I want to make songs like Real Rapper and throw that ass for Rob. Like, nigga, I'm a player nigga, you feel me? Like, I ain't just, like, sitting around just bars all day. Really, I don't even rap like that, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But this was like... It started with production, right? You find the right production. If you could rap, that really make it easy. So my motto be, let me find beats that any nigga could rap on. You feel me? But every nigga can't rap like me. So it's like simple beats. Do you on them hoes? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't have to dumb down nothing. Like, I realized that you dumb down the production. You know what I'm saying? You make simple hooks. I don't have to dumb down my raps, though.
Yeah.
People don't want to hear a dumb rap from me. Even on Real Rapper, the whole concept of that is, nigga, I don't normally make these type of records, but I can.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, I'm from Houston, nigga. I'm from A-Leaf, nigga.
Yeah.
I was at the Majestic Hall, nigga. You feel me? I'm at Funplex.
International Ballroom.
Starlight International Ballroom.
They can say Funplex. That's a zone, nigga.
J.U. Hall, you feel me?
I've
been going out, man. I swear to God, bro. I'm a Timber Hollow baby originally. You got to think about that. From Cook Road. I've been going to Starlight, nigga, since fourth grade every Friday.
Remember Thursdays? I used to have a dollar skate night and shit.
Nigga, going to lock-ins and shit, man. So
I've
been going out all my life, basically. So it's like, it ain't never been a thing. It just, when you get tagged with this label of, like, being a lyricist, niggas be acting like I be making music like Talib Kweli or something. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I really don't. But hey, you
and
know?
That was the dope thing. Like, it was something on here, like, I think Matthew said it on the episode. He was like, Rob got an ass-shaking song with bars in it? And I'm like, bro, like, the nigga did his fucking thing, bro.
Man, that's how you do it. And then, I'm going to say this, man. My homegirls on Clubhouse and shit kind of inspired a couple of them records like that, Throw That Ass for Rob.
Uh-huh.
Like, just hanging out more. See, I'm a writer that pretty much write off experiences. You hadn't... I don't go out Galactic Vision, Tortoise Theory. I'm not going out, nigga, so you're not hearing them type of songs.
True. Right.
This album, I go out a little more. I'm around a lot more women.
That's true.
The experiences, you feel me? I can write easier.
Yeah.
It's hard for me to write.
I remember when I first seen you post Real Rapper, I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I ain't never heard no shit like that from Rob, but that hoe is jamming.
And then I've been trying to get niggas to sample me a bounce beat for years. Me and Donnie Houston, actually, we had sampled that Mac, that Murder, mm-hmm. Kill, but we never finished it.
Mm-hmm.
And then a nigga sent me a beat that kind of had that same Trigger Man sample, but that shit was trash, though. And that nigga Tommy Two Guns, man, that nigga sent me that shit, and I was like, yeah, bro, when I heard that beat...
You knew it.
I knew it. So, like, I'm finna put a push on it and shit, man, like, and see where it go, man. Like, see where it go.
Like I said, I gave that hoe a 4-5, bro. That hoe gets play for shit show.
And that's what the goal was, man. It was just to get... I thought they said my daughter was watching. I was about to say, baby mama, you can go on your real page. You don't got to spy on me. I am where I say I am. Shout out my brother Sam, man. He just came on the live and shit. But, yeah, nah, nigga, I just be rapping, bro.
Yeah.
At this stage, man, like, where I'm at with it, whatever I want to rap about, I rap about it. And it comes out, man. I got a new album ready to go in terms of recording. Like, I'm going to go record in the next couple weeks.
Damn.
I'm not saying I'm going to put it out right away, but...
Right.
You got some shit
like,
ready.
I got 13 songs that's ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So...
Damn. Okay. Yeah,
nigga just going to stay writing because...
Got to stay ahead of the game.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this, though. So, recently, you was in the Clubhouse... Is it Clubhouse?
Yes.
That's how I met it. That's how I heard about it.
Yeah, Clubhouse chat room. And you, yeah.
Oh, I had this question for later. Is this about your guy?
Yes, it is.
I got you.
Okay.
This about Pusha T?
We'll get to that later.
Pusha T? Let's hear from the first. This is your first Rob project?
Yeah, for sure.
What you thought about it?
I gave it a 4, bro.
Okay.
I thought the raps was dope.
Okay.
The one song I didn't like was the Throw That Ass for Rob song. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna hold you to it. That's what you wanted to do. It was your
album.
Shit was live, though.
Yeah.
The Big Bob freestyle.
That nigga said, it's your album. Dude,
yeah,
you.
I can't tell a nigga to doing this shit.
Shit, I do it all the time.
But, like, the did thing get beat records, up one day? I can't expect, like, I knew with them, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, for sure.
Like, I'm not tripping. You feel me?
Yeah, for sure.
That's for a certain element.
Right.
It worked where it worked at.
Right.
But it worked in the flow of the album, too.
And that's what's crazy. If you hear it in the club, though, and they throwing it ass for Rob.
It worked in the flow of the album. I wouldn't have put it on.
They throwing it for Rob. Hey, they're not throwing it for you.
They're not throwing it for you.
They're not throwing it for me. Yeah.
You could change the name, man. Change the name.
She throw it for Tubbs. Hey, Tubbs, who that is?
You could change the name. Who that lean from now? I don't know who that is, man. But nigga just... I don't know, man. I might make me some more pussy popping records, man. I need some money.
Hey, shit show.
I might go Flow Rider on y'all niggas, man. Fuck y'all. Go Pit Bull.
Your ass don't never had no shirt on already, like, so
fuck
shit.
It, man.
You might as well.
Stop rapping. I ain't making no more Big Bob freestyles, no more corner store legends.
Nah, I'm going to need a freestyle.
Pussy poppers.
Hey, whatever bring the motherfucking money in, I ain't mad at it.
That's what we trying to do, ain't we? Like, I mean,
trying to get paid.
Man, this shit.
Rob rapping about apple bottom jeans. And boots with the fur.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Fat asses, you know?
Yeah, fat asses.
Everybody
nigga.
Like fat asses.
Oh, nigga, for sure. Nigga don't like a fat ass. He's something wrong with
him. He's a weirdo.
Yeah. He's a weirdo.
He's a weirdo.
Yeah.
Fat ass ain't hurt nobody.
Didn't hurt no one.
Military Minded was my favorite track on the album.
That's my daughter's favorite.
That shit hard. That hoe was hard.
Talk about the little one?
My little one.
Oh, man.
It fucked me up one day, bro. I'm driving her to school and she in the back seat saying, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday.
Yeah, right.
I look, I'm like, all right. And she's singing the words.
Yeah.
She talking about kick dough, kick dough. I'm like, baby, do you know what you sing?
Yeah, right.
But like that record was crazy because like Derek was playing records in the studio.
Yeah.
And he skipped. I'm like, nigga, go back to that hoe. You feel me? And I heard it. I'm like, man, I had this melody in my head. Mm-hmm. I probably wrote the song in about 15, 20 minutes, man. And then we went and recorded it. Like,
yeah. One take?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
Nigga so said 15 minutes. Do you write down or you just.
Nah, I mean, well, I haven't been writing on paper in a while.
But on, but on through the phone.
My phone,
yeah, yeah,
I have
sure.
been writing on my. Like, that was. I actually. The Tortoise Theory was the first album I ever wrote raps in my phone like that. You okay. feel me? I was a stickler for writing on paper.
Right, mm-hmm. right, right.
But I don't. That whole not writing shit. Like, them niggas not freestyling,
it don't hype you up like
that. That's a weird flex, bro. We don't care. Like, we really don't care. Right.
That's like y'all niggas coming in here, punching in y'all podcast. You feel me? Like,
yeah, right.
It's like, nigga right. be taking 15 takes to do one verse.
Yeah, for sure.
And I ain't knocking it. If your shit tight, it's tight. You feel
right,
me?
Right,
but,
right.
like, if my flex is put the beat on and see who finish faster.
Yeah, right.
And see who's tightest, nigga.
Right.
Yeah. I'm going to finish faster and I'm going to write a tighter verse than you.
Yeah, yeah, right.
So, like, that's my flex. But, nah, I like to write. I've been writing back in notebooks with this new shit.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Got to keep it somewhat old school.
For sure. Now, let me ask you, how long have you been in the game?
He said 25 years.
Man, nah.
Well, nah, but go
nah,
ahead.
Yeah. I was talking about trapping.
Yeah, yeah.
As far as in the
yeah. Nah, that.
Same thing.
No,
same
yeah.
But.
Galette a real nigga, bro.
Nah,
I ain't saying he ain't.
No, I'm just saying. Right.
So my first real album.
I hear it in the raps.
The first sure. real album dropped in 2005.
Okay.
But I kind of. I've been floating around since about 2000, 2001.
Okay.
Trying to figure out how to get on the scene. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Right,
I was battle
right.
rapping.
Okay.
I was putting out little mixtapes here and there.
Okay.
Nothing like professional, so
right.
to speak. But
right.
Niggas in the hood, I was going to niggas' schools. That's really how I know a lot of niggas.
Okay.
I used to go to any school that a nigga said he could rap at.
Right.
Dulles, Worthing,
yeah.
Yates, Sharpstown, yeah. Willery. It really didn't matter. Yeah. Anybody that could rap in that era, nigga, we would go like try to find them. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And I was trying to prove I was the hardest rapper. And it was like, shit, I just
kinda
was rapping.
Go from there.
And then met some people. Then you get the right production. And it's like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
Nigga got an album.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
From there, I just kind of, I've been blessed in the sense that, like, a lot of niggas be struggling for production. And, I ain't, since I got on in that sense,
yeah.
I ain't never struggled for production.
Right.
Like, recording, none of that shit. You feel me? Like, niggas want to work with me. So,
yeah.
I work with whoever want to work with me. And I've been blessed to have relationships with, like, Pug Tunes and Donnie Houston.
Right.
Solo Hendrix and these niggas.
My homie, George Young.
Man,
one of my favorite songs.
Oh, yeah. Nah, man. Mankind in here, man. Mankind know what's up, man. We were going to the chop shop, nigga.
Yeah.
Recording, nigga. When you couldn't, you got to record straight through. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like,
no,
you can't record your verse, then stop, then, nah, you got to record your hook, verse, hook, the whole thing.
Damn,
you feel me?
In one time.
You know what I'm saying? Niggas was doing that type of stuff. And
yeah.
So I guess officially, I'm like, what, 2005 to 2022. So what, that's 17 years?
Yeah.
That shit crazy, man. But outside of that, nigga, I really been writing raps. I swear for, man, since about 2-3 years old, man.
I was just at my T. Jones house the other day.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, in that sense, I think I recorded my first song in, like, 4th, 5th grade. Me and my niggas, man, Jay Styles, JD Gator, the 40 Gators. You know what I'm saying? We had been recording since we was kids, man.
Damn. Can you imagine a 5th grade Galette?
Nigga.
I ain't never been trash, bro. Like, I ain't saying I always was, like, whatever level I was on, I was good at that level. You feel me?
When I first seen Rob, we was at Fox Hollow. We was out there on the patio. I had never seen him before. Somehow I missed Rob because we grew up same fucking street.
Yeah.
But Preach, me and Preach was out there. He a couple years older than me. But Preach was out there, and he was like, this the best rapper in the city. And I'm like, this nigga gotta be good if Preach saying this shit.
Yeah.
And I think you were still going by Critical then.
Man, I don't know, because I changed.
Wait, talking about, you Critical?
Yeah, I'm Critical.
You Critical?
Didn't know that, bro.
Yeah.
Didn't know that. Yeah. You Critical. Okay, I definitely heard that.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Nah, nigga, that
shit.
That's
crazy.
Yeah, that's me.
I didn't know that, bro.
That's me.
I knew you as Rob Gillette, my nigga.
Yeah, I changed my name in 2011, I think.
Damn.
Like, Big Critic popped off.
Yeah.
And this little baby, the baby shit wasn't.
Yeah.
We're not, that's not the era I'm from, nigga. Right. So I'm, man. And truth be told, I didn't want to like Big Crit, man. And I love Big Crit music.
Yeah,
like,
right.
At first, though, I was hating like a motherfucker. Boy, man, fuck this nigga, man. Damn, bro, like, people calling and shit. But,
damn.
I was mad, nigga.
I've
been grinding that since seventh grade, you feel me?
Damn.
I've been grinding Critical since seventh grade. So I go from 12 years old to 26, 27.
Yeah, right.
As Critical.
This new nigga come out.
And then this new nigga. And then it don't help that we similar.
Yeah.
Styles.
You feel me?
Right.
He said that,
like, man, he sound like Critical a little bit. Yeah, but once I got past that shit, I was like, oh yeah, this nigga rapping on
it didn't. So I'm like, man, how the fuck I'm gonna come up with a new rap name, dog? It just. Initially, I was gonna go by my grandfather's name, B.D. Gillette.
Okay.
Because my best friend Cameron was like, man, you should use your name. And I'm like, man, niggas gonna have issues. Niggas saying my volume low. Hey, that's as loud as it go, guys. Yeah, so I was like, Gillette. Then he was like, nobody ever called me Rob. Let me say that.
Yeah.
Like, now, when I was little, niggas would call me Rob Deep. But everybody called me Robbo.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Gillette, like in the Gillette hood, niggas. Because it's a few niggas named Robert.
Nigga, I've been going by Tubbs since.
Yeah.
Forever,
since
nigga.
Tubbs been
yeah,
Tubbs.
Yeah, since Tubbs
you got
been
a
Tubbs.
Couple popular niggas with the same name.
Right.
Y'all
right.
go it default yeah. last
right,
name.
Right.
So
right.
niggas been saying Gillette.
Yeah.
And my bro was like, man, go by Rob Gillette. And I'm like, shit, all right. That's what I'm going by. And then, nigga, I changed my Twitter. And nigga was like, man, who the fuck is that?
Yeah.
And ever since then, man, the shit just worked. Yeah. Like, all right. I miss Critical, though, man. That allowed me to be a nutcase, man. Ooh, nigga was tripping back then, bro. Y'all, thank God we wasn't on social media. Man, we was jumping off stage, whooping niggas. And
yeah,
you cut our mic off early, man. We throwing your mic in there, swinging it around and throwing your mic on the ground and daring you to fuck with us, man. Like,
damn.
Yeah, we was wild, man. Tripping. And I'm little, man, thinking back on this, man, I'm little than a motherfucker, dog.
Yeah.
But...
shit, fuck it.
Fuck it.
Yeah. There you go.
Fuck it.
There you go.
Yeah.
You want to give your finally give your grade?
I gave it a 5.
Of course.
It was my most listened to album of 2021.
Oh, shit. That one came out late in 2021, too.
Yeah, they told you I mean until I ran that bitch back. You know, I work outside, so I put the shit on and just.
I think the second day it came out, I'm like, bro, this is all I listened to today.
Yeah. I did that a few days.
I could tell.
Yeah.
Man, niggas was, all right, so when I dropped it, man, and let me tell you a funny story, man. So when I'm shooting the video for the intro, right, so I'm like, I'm going to go to two spots. I'm going to shoot on Cook Road, I'm going to shoot on the block. You feel me? Like, these my whatever.
Yeah.
I go to Cook Road, nigga, it's no issues. Nigga, it's breezy.
Love.
Man, I get to the 97, a nigga tried to press me for shooting a video, bro.
For real?
Yeah.
Not knowing who you was.
Yeah, he didn't. Luckily, my nigga was on the block, and it worked. And in a funny way, it worked out because a lot of young niggas don't know me.
Yeah.
Because, I'm not hanging out on the block like that no more.
Right,
you feel
right,
me?
Right,
like,
right.
I'm 30-something years old, nigga.
Right.
Like, I got kids and health issues, nigga.
Yeah, right.
So, like,
you chilling. You low-key,
And when I'm, like, with the Rice, nigga, I was on West Belford and Fondren.
Yeah.
With my little cousin and them, they doing their thing, nigga. Yeah. I got my little setup.
Yeah.
I still be on the block, but just I hadn't been on my block.
Yeah.
So I get it, nigga. You don't know me because I don't know you.
Yeah.
But it worked out because once certain people, you know what I'm saying, find out, nigga, it's like, wait a minute, nigga, that's a nigga you can't really do like that. You feel me? So it worked out.
Yeah, OG.
Yeah, it's like, I ain't gonna come around like stumping like I'm like some gang leader or something. Yeah. It's gang politics that I don't get involved in because I ain't no gang member. You feel me? But just far as just in my neighborhood.
Just real niggas knowing.
Yeah, nah, yeah, in my neighborhood, from my era, nigga, like, nah, I'm going to get grand respect always because I was one of the niggas that was actually, like...
On the block.
Just on the... And not just even on, like, terrorizing some shit, right. You feel me?
Just in the hood, though.
Just not being a scary nigga. Right, nigga was on the hoes.
Right.
Nigga had hands.
Right.
We was rapping.
Yeah.
Like, and whatever was in the streets was in the streets, you feel me?
For sure.
So the hood fucked with me, and then I give back to the community. I work for my community. I'm there with them kids when I'm able, like, when my body allows, you feel me?
Right, right, for sure.
So the neighborhood gonna show love on that end, man, so that's what it is.
For sure, for sure.
So everybody at this table, minus Mathis, as not being here, always missing work, sad, sad case, was here for the top 15 episode. And I know when you when you heard the episode, you did have like questions about how certain artists on the independent level, it's okay for them niggas to be viewed.
Yeah.
And you know, we had our categories where it was like lyrics, production, impact,
replay value.
Yeah, replay value and stuff like that. And some other people did ask this on Twitter too. They was like, well, how do you gauge the production of, say, a nigga like Ross or Drake who can go to top-notch niggas in the world versus independent niggas, is that an argument they always gonna lose and shit like that?
I don't think so, man, because, look, nowadays, all these niggas is using the same fucking sound kits. These shits, you feel me? So, like, I even though Pug not on this album, I know I can go get some Pug production, nigga, that's as good as anything, you feel me? Yeah. The only difference between some of these producers and the majors, nigga, is nobody major is rapped on their beats.
Yeah.
So it's like, I think definitely since Abortion dropped, that was 2012, like all my production, man, been pretty straight. You feel me? Like I done had a real good selection of beats. So I don't think it matter. You know what I'm saying? Like these niggas ain't, when you listen to a nigga album now, you say, we got the same drum kit y'all got, boss, so it is what it is.
Tubbs, you ready to defend Pusha T?
Oh, for sure, all day.
And let me say this about Pusha T, man.
I did push-ups before Rob came in.
Let me say this about Pusha T. I am a Clips fan, man.
I know you are. I heard it.
I love Lord Willing. You feel me?
Yeah. Everybody did.
I'm not cool. against Pusha T.
I'm lying. I'm lying.
Don't do that.
But, This notion that he like a God level rapper, dog, I don't hear it, my nigga.
I was in the room whenever you, me and Corey Terry, we was at work.
Yeah.
Was in the room when you started the chat, whatever. Yeah. And then it was so much disrespect in that room because I'm not gonna say he's God level rap, but he's elite though.
He's elite.
I mean,
he's elite.
I say he's good to great. Somewhere in between there.
But not great to elite?
No.
Why?
I don't. Like,
Because the only thing that, You was naming like...
The only thing I hear about... Like, he got good timing. He's never off beat. I give him that.
Okay.
Like, that's
hard
a hell of
thing
a...
thing to do.
Yeah.
Right, and lyrics are on point.
He's... It's like... When you got to get nitpicky with a nigga, you know he a good rapper.
Right.
So
true,
he's not
true.
A trash rapper. Like,
not at all.
Some niggas was taking that as me saying, like, he's sorry. I'm like, bro, he's not sorry. But when I hear him, I guess it's because the nostalgia of a nigga that hasn't switched up, you feel me?
Okay.
He stayed consistent with the things that he talking about.
Definitely.
It's nostalgic, you feel me?
Right.
Like, he ain't trying to make... The do-da-da-do-da rap.
Yeah, right. He not switching the shit at all.
But it's like, it ain't really improved to me. You feel me?
So what tier would you put him on, B? Like who else is on his tier? If you're saying great to elite. I wonder who's on that tier so I can say if I feel you or if now you fucking dripping.
Great to elite. So elite being top tier, right?
Yeah.
Well, I would say God level rapping is top tier.
So my God level is Jay.
Of course.
Period.
Mm-hmm.
So elite level rapping?
Mm-hmm.
Push would be elite. Mm-hmm. Who else? You can put Drake up there. Drake as elite. He could put give me a second. I'm on the spot right now. Give me a second.
It's hard to do when
I would make Drake an elite level songwriter.
Elite level artist.
Yeah.
Artist.
But just rapper.
Elite level. Yeah. Rapper. I can use you elite level artist.
Yeah.
But not
He's
not
a rapper.
And I give Drake so much heat, but he's not. Elite level rapper would be Kanye.
Boy, get the fuck out of here.
Nah, man.
You can't be elite and not write your own shit.
When I say elite level
rapper, bro. Elite. Kanye not elite, bro.
You gonna name a nigga elite that don't write his own shit?
Okay.
We talking about Lupe.
So
we talking about Royce da 5'9". We talking about 96 to 2005 Bun B. You feel me? We talking about
this nigga named Kanye. I want to mute your mic for naming Kanye. No. Bro.
Okay, so wait. So I'll say okay. So if
that's
you know,
elite,
if
98 to 03, 04 Eminem is elite.
That's disrespectful to rappers, bro.
No, because you can't, bro. Because Kanye wrote most of his raps in the beginning.
Hey, one thing I did notice in this documentary.
Shut
you
up.
Never saw that nigga write shit down, did you?
No.
And then Rhymefest's verse in the documentary is Kanye's verse.
It starts off the same.
But it's different, bro. You know, I'm not finna talk.
I'm not finna argue with
this nigga here.
Like,
I'm right.
When you listen, so put him on the record with Black Thought.
I mean, to be honest with
Black Thought is elite level rapper.
Yeah,
that's elite.
But to be honest with you, it's not too many elite level rappers right now.
Black Jada, Thought. Would you call Jada an elite level rapper?
No.
I come good to great.
I would say, because I put
Jada and Pusha in the same class.
I kind of do,
no.
too.
Fuck.
I think Jada's
fuck
a
no.
little better.
Tripping,
fuck
bro.
No. As of right now?
You tripping, bro.
As of right now, Jada and Push?
And Legacy, period, yes. I put
Jason
them on the same
Phillips.
Level.
Legacy, if you're talking about that, but right now, though,
I put them at the same level.
Out. This next Push album is gonna be fucking phenomenal.
I'm in the car with you, bro.
How long?
I'm in the car with you.
You in the trunk. Nigga.
What is it gonna be? Seven songs again?
Like I told, like put
nigga,
it.
Nigga, it could be one.
Put it in sports.
I'm straight.
Put it in sports terms. You feel me?
I could cut My Name Is My Name down to seven songs and make it better than the one that y'all praise.
My Name Is My Name? Oh, yeah, that's fine.
The seven best songs on that album are better than the seven songs on that Kanye album.
Yeah, I thought that Daytona album.
Daytona was
dope.
Thought about it?
There's seven better songs on My Name Is My Name than there are on Daytona.
I didn't hear best album of the year.
No way, bro.
I heard.
I got you tomorrow. Don't worry.
I thought
please
it was
let
straight.
Me know.
Don't
please,
worry.
If I'm wrong, I'll admit it.
Originally, okay. I thought Daytona was the best album of the year. I went back. I listened. And this was in the same day. I listened to Daytona. I listened to Victory Lap. Mm-hmm. Anniversary of Victory Lap released today. Yes. And I listened to the Travis Scott album, Astroworld. Astroworld was the best album that came out
I gave
year.
Victory Man, Lap and Mac Miller that title that year.
Really?
That Mac Miller album was hard to me.
That was the Swimming?
Yeah. That was a hard album. But like, nah, the Daytona was straight, man.
Daytona was stupid.
I ran it back recently.
Astroworld was the best album.
When Daytona didn't miss, my nigga.
What was better than Astroworld?
I never listened to Astroworld straight through, so
really?
I don't know.
DJ, I'm asking you, what was better than Astroworld?
Victory Lap? Off top. J-Rock album.
J-Rock
album was dumb hard. No, J-Rock came out the year before.
No, it was the same year.
2017, huh?
No, we looked it up because we was arguing about it on Twitter.
Was that 17 or 18?
It was 18. So, we was arguing about it on Twitter. The thing about Astroworld is great production, phenomenal production. Mm-hmm. It beats every album that year for production. But that's where it stops. I gotta get to the raps. And when I get to the raps, Travis is here, his features are here, and then everybody else's albums that year are here.
But where was his features?
I put Cole above that, because Cole rapped better than that nigga, too.
Oh, KOD?
Yes.
KOD was
here. KOD was all right.
But where were the KOD. Features? The Drake features, I mean,
can I get some more
Travis
shit,
features. What album were they on?
They were on Astroworld.
Okay.
But
I don't give a fuck.
That's like,
if I make an album and I got Rob on every fucking song.
And Rob, I rap you on every fucking song.
My album's still hard.
That's why I didn't give Witchcraft that much. That's why I don't give Homeboy that much credit either.
Who was Homeboy?
Jay Elect.
You had Hove on every track, man.
True.
Fuck, I'm supposed to do
that.
That's true. You waited 15 years to put out a debut album, and your debut album has the greatest rapper of all time on every song.
Is it Watch the Throne too?
I still say Jay Electronica had the second best verse last year of rap.
But anyway,
it was on your boy. It was on Hill Wears Hermes.
I get
it. It was
verse,
over that.
That oh, no, verse no, it was on. Dumb
yeah,
hard.
Yeah. Oh, nigga, was it?
If there's yes, like, if there's like 5 or 6 tiers.
Yes, it was.
And Hov being the top,
is anybody on the level with Hov?
I put Andre up there.
I think, man, with Hov,
I put a lot of niggas up there.
That's the thing with Hov.
I put Lupe up there. I put Nas up there.
I be calling Hov the default GOAT.
I ain't gonna do you like that.
I know.
I be fucking with Jay-Z fans, man, because Jay-Z fans are really they're not objective at all, man.
But that's no one better than Jay right now, though.
It is.
I
mean, it's not, but people won't let you even argue or say anything. Like,
look.
If I say somebody had a better verse than Jay on the song, most niggas gonna argue.
Because people get disrespectful with they take sometimes.
Ask yourself
and I
this.
Be like,
so what's the criteria of a great rapper, right?
Bars.
Is Jay the top bar guy?
He won't bar you to death?
Okay, when you say okay, hold on. So this is
I think his averages are going to average out.
No, I got you.
That's what makes him the best, because he's gonna be
the
highest amongst, like, he'll be 2 or 3, 4 or 5 in every category.
And the thing also about Jay is, when you look at it, when you ask those type of questions, there are guys better, because one, I have some of my favorite rappers on my list, I think can rap better than Hov, but they don't have the limelight of a Hov. So, like, of course, you can name a Black Thought, you can name a Royce, you can name a Joe Budden, you can name a whole lot of niggas. But niggas don't, people, the masses don't listen
to them.
Nobody's
gonna listen to them.
Yeah, so when you start talking about greatest, you gotta add the fact that, okay, we talking about the niggas that are like if you go to the niggas that are elite in status, he is the best rapper to me out of elite in status.
Because his two biggest competitors didn't live long, you know? Like, Nas is my nigga, but.
Wait. Two greatest competitors? Get the fuck out of here, Rob.
Look, I know niggas love to get on this soapbox and say Pac can't rap.
He can't.
I didn't say that. I'm not gonna say
niggas
that.
Niggas love to say that Pac can't rap.
Dog. He wasn't that good, Rob.
He was at
his time, he wasn't even the best rapper.
Man, at his time, the only guy that you could have said was better than him was Ice Cube.
Snoop
came out in one album. That was 94. Snoop had that run.
And was better and was a bigger artist than fucking Tupac.
That was a big album.
That was a huge album.
He was bigger than Tupac.
Pac was huge, though.
No, he was bigger and better
than Tupac.
No, he wasn't better than Tupac.
At that time, he was bigger and better than...
I don't think...
Me Against the World, All Eyes on Me, Machiavelli. Like,
he was bigger and better. He was bigger and better.
You see what
than
I mean
Tupac.
By Jay-Z fans?
Hey, this Jay-Z fan didn't say nothing.
Dog, that nigga.
Where did this shit come from?
I don't know if
this idea that Pac can't
know
rap,
if
man.
Snoop was better.
I'm not saying he can't rap. I'm just
being
saying,
an adult listening to this nigga after listening
as an
to
adult,
many,
you should
it
feel
is,
him more.
Tupac Tupac was able to get his point across without being lyrical miracle.
It
it was passionate and people felt it. So I think all of those things together, it was easily digestible most times. You could feel the passion in the rhymes. I think those things really helped Tupac
for sure.
Raps. And the songs jam most of the time.
He was charismatic. He was captivating.
It's
his
a
voice.
Jam factor that has to come with music. Now, I think that's why Hov is better than all East Coast rappers, because them niggas seem to not want to jam sometimes.
Yeah.
They want to bar you to death. Don't nobody want to hear that all the time, man. Like, Hov found a healthy medium. I give Hov his just due, but I'm like, man, y'all be acting like this nigga got a flawless record, and he don't. He don't.
He got about 95.
He don't have a flawless record.
Got a 95.
No, man. That nigga. Look, all right, so we looking at Reasonable Doubt is flawless.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Blueprint 1, that's close to flawless. Black Album is close to flawless.
Blueprint 2 is not close to flawless?
No.
Blueprint 2, Blueprint if, 2 if it was one album.
If you condense it, it can be
flawless. The
best
songs on one album?
So 2.1. Blueprint
2.1. No, because I still don't think
it was real. I put American Gangster over there and 444.
I put American Gangster over there.
But then you start going into like the Dynasty, that's an okay album.
But that's a compilation album.
Okay album.
Okay.
No, actually, that's a sorry album.
Nah, Volume 3 was dope.
Volume 3 is sorry.
Volume 3 was dope.
Y'all need to go back and listen to that album, man. That shit's sorry.
Volume 3 was dope.
Volume 1, yeah. Volume 2, it had the hits, but it's...
Volume 2 had the hits. But it wasn't... After that...
It's like, yeah. I like Kingdom Come just listening to it.
Oh, hell no.
It's not great.
I'm done talking to you, Rob.
No. It's not a great album, but it's not a bad album.
Kingdom Come had...
That everybody... The way everybody made it seem, no,
Kingdom
it was
had Beach Chair and
Do You Wanna Ride
in 30 something. Yeah,
had a couple good records, man.
That was a pretty good album. I fuck with Kingdom Come.
It's like he niggas be acting like Hov ain't got like nah. The niggas Blueprint 3 and the Magna Carta and like
I'm with you on the Magna Carta.
These hoes
is
like he got a couple ends. You feel me?
He got like 2 ends.
The only nigga that really ain't got no flaws in his track record, man, is Brad Jordan.
Oh yeah, that's Scarface.
Album wise, now you can say it's better niggas like
than him, but
technically,
I got Face in my top five, so I'm not gonna say shit.
Album, he don't have a bad album.
I'm not gonna say shit.
I'm gonna tell a nigga next time he come in my store. I'm like, man,
Richard. Ask that nigga why he ain't get on none of them Kanye records. That's what you need to ask that nigga.
No, I'm definitely. Oh, were you disgusted by his retainers? I'm definitely gonna ask Brad that. That nigga came in my store one time. I was like, duh.
Out here to the right, I think the code is 315 or 513.
Yeah. 315. But yeah, nah, that nigga, speaking of the documentary, that nigga was...
Yeah, we can talk about that real quick.
Yeah. That nigga was disgusted.
Genius, the part one of the Kanye documentary
great,
dropped
bro.
On Netflix this week.
It was ass.
Yeah, she was
great. No, I'm sorry.
He fucking with you, bro. He fucking with you.
You see how I'm about to jump down your throat? Pause. Like, yeah, pause.
Whoa.
But yeah, nigga, like, I think Genius, that documentary was fucking awesome, bro. I'm a Kanye
we know.
Stan, my nigga. Know. Like, I remember back when Kanye did the Rhythm and Rhyme on MTV when it was the College Dropout album. Ah, she was fucking perfect, bro.
That documentary.
Anything. I'm sorry. I mean to cut you off. Anything that was related to Kanye, bro, I watched that shit, nigga.
So you like me have seen some of this footage?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
Nigga sliding down the thing. I seen the pool table footage. I seen the bitch in Harold's Chicken. Mm-hmm. I seen that footage. Cause that was on the
video.
Yeah,
on
the video. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
I seen
him and
the,
Face walking to the studio.
Right, I seen that because that was on the Face video.
Yeah.
I seen him in the hallway when they gave him the chain because that was the first time he met Pharrell. And what's crazy is I didn't know back in the day, I didn't know that was Pharrell. No, niggas didn't know Pharrell. Back when Kanye video came out, niggas didn't know who Pharrell was.
Boy, you ain't watch Uncut? Well, the lap dance video went platinum, nigga.
Yeah, but nigga, did you know who Pharrell was?
I did.
Okay, well you.
I paid attention to production. I was going to be a producer back then.
So you was an AV kid. It's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Dog, put.
get a case, nigga. Goddamn.
You good?
Yeah, but I mean, but this Kanye documentary was very refreshing. I love it. I watched it twice. I
Damn.
Can't wait for the second one. Yeah, nigga, I'm Kanye fan, bro. Like, for real.
How many points is it going to be?
I think three.
Nigga, I can't wait till they say we got a J documentary. Nigga, I am feet
You taking off work?
Yes. You know how many times I watch backstage? Nigga, I watch backstage like it's motherfucking church.
That shit on Amazon.
Yes, I know, nigga. I watch it on Amazon.
I watch that hell too.
Bro, that shit is great.
I thought the documentary was very good. And then... Donda West came on and it got better. See the way this nigga lit up.
His mom awesome, bro.
Bro.
But then that gives you insight to when she passed away.
Why what happened?
That nigga went to
happened.
A deep hole, nigga.
It made perfect sense, bro.
Bro.
But like to see the sequence of him getting turned down, going to see his mom and how that just brightened his
My nigga,
this whole day, bro.
This nigga was super excited to present a record that had Talib Kweli and Mos Def on it from Raucous Records. First off, this nigga walked in to a room and presented his record, and them niggas having a full fucking conversation.
Bro, like nothing's happening.
Like this nigga not even in here performing his record. Like any nigga, like if we ain't here having a podcast, nigga, well, not even having a podcast, we in conversation, nigga, I'm demoing my record. All right, cool, mm-hmm. cool. You demoing, we paying attention to you. Somebody else come in, we just, all right, fuck that nigga.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that shit was crazy.
Like my nigga, and it wasn't even a trash ass song. It was the one with
Lauryn Hill.
Exactly.
But it wasn't Lauryn Hill at the time.
No, it was Selena. Yeah.
It wasn't even Selena yet. That was somebody. That was the girl that was in the apartment at that time.
Oh, the chick with the short hair? Yeah. But dog, but come on, bro. It was a great ass record.
Yeah.
It was a platinum record.
And they talked over that like it was a bad preview.
And then the bitch with the
y'all gonna make me go home and watch this whole tonight.
Right, yeah.
Nah,
bro.
Save it for the plane, bro.
Save it for the plane. But dog, like the thing is, bro, like that shit was so fucking disrespectful. I see where this nigga come from, where niggas just they was shitting on this nigga before he even made it. And then the way Dame Dash treated the nigga, like, even in the commentary, was like, oh, yeah, Dame just kind of wanted that nigga hanging around because he wanted beats for his artist.
And it's crazy because, like, every time somebody...
I think he's openly said that before.
He said that.
Yeah.
Yeah, he said that by now. Yeah.
Every time they mention Kanye, new up-and-coming producer, producer.
Yeah, right.
Producer. And that's like, bro, this nigga been trying to rap for y'all.
Yeah, right.
Let him rap, bro. Like, hear him out.
Nigga been rapping since been rapping. I didn't know about the Raucous thing.
Huh?
Dame didn't want the nigga to rap.
Nah, he wanted him as a producer.
He wanted him to just be in there pumping out beats.
I knew about Joey 3H from Capital because he talked about that shit in the last track.
Yeah.
I didn't know about the Raucous Records thing though. Yeah. I didn't know Raucous was trying to sign it. Well, was about to sign that nigga.
Every time I hear that name, I think of Brown Sugar, bro.
That's for a Raucous. Raucous might still be around to this day.
Yeah, the Lyricist Lounge.
You feel me?
They might still be around to this
they
day.
They might have, yeah. Because them niggas had, what, Lyricist Lounge?
Yeah. Could you that imagine?
Was, do you remember Lyricist Lounge?
Mos Def and Talib had Kanye in their back pocket.
Yeah.
Yes, nigga.
Careers would have been different. A lot for of sure. careers would have been different.
What was Talib's album? That mixtape? Beautiful, the Beautiful Struggle.
Yeah,
the Beautiful Struggle was crazy. Yeah. That mixtape was crazy.
I'm gonna have to run that, huh?
Bro, that shit was crazy. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that documentary live though.
Can you imagine Kanye on Raucous?
Huh? Dog. Be careful, bro.
Get packing.
All right, for sure. All right, man. Y'all be safe. Hey, bring me back some Starbucks, nigga.
This nigga want some coffee.
Yeah.
Nigga, they gonna smell coffee and think you got dope in there, bitch, nigga.
Yeah, for real. Hey, bring some edibles, nigga. All right, bet.
That'll work. I thought that hoe was fire. I started watching that hoe today at work because motherfuckers was moving slow as shit and it was raining outside. I ain't gonna get wet. So, fuck that.
See your job description, nigga. Go get
rain, sleet, snow, all that shit. Fuck you, nigga. So I watched that. I was sitting in my case watching that shit, bro. That shit was fire. I couldn't cut that shit off. And then
you came, bro.
I was like, look, man. I hope y'all niggas finish. I hope y'all niggas don't finish before I'm done watching this documentary because I ain't stopping the documentary to go outside. So I don't give a fuck. But it was dope to see, like, just the idea that Cootie had to stop what he was doing to follow this nigga around.
Right.
Like, not only did he have to have faith in himself, you had to have a lot of faith in Kanye. And then the fact that even though Kanye has been made it, you still, like, this footage is just now coming out.
No, but he's still with him to this day, though.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, like, because I seen a clip when Kanye... Well, actually, in 2020, Kanye was in DR. What? I think we all seen that clip.
Mm-hmm.
And he was talking about Cootie. Mm-hmm. Cootie was with him.
That's at the beginning of the thing. That's where he was at the beginning.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so yeah.
Uh-huh.
So I actually remember that nigga Cootie from Comic View.
Uh-huh.
That was dope to see.
Yeah, right. I remember that nigga. I was like, oh, I thought that nigga was fucking not RNSJ. What's the other nigga that be doing the Jay-Z voice? the nigga from New York.
Eric Spears?
Yeah, I thought he was that yeah, nigga. Yeah. Anyways. But yeah, I it's fucking phenomenal.
It's just though, yeah, I get the first part of it was completely fucking flawless. I ain't got no gripes with this fucking shit. It was very interesting to watch all the way through.
Come out on what, the 23rd?
Yeah, the next
yeah, something like
one.
That.
That shit was crazy.
We could stick in tune with TV. We could do our own thing right now.
Shit, let's go to fucking Fresh Prince.
It's Bel Air.
I haven't watched it.
Oh, whatever.
How much y'all think about it?
You haven't?
No, I haven't. I've been working, bro.
Can we talk about it?
Nigga, yeah, it's fucking Fresh Prince. Huh?
See, y'all got to stop that shit. That's what you don't do. That's how you go in there and shit and get yourself disappointed like these motherfuckers on social media.
This is true.
I ain't gonna lie. My wife was like, I don't like this Carlson.
But that's their fault.
Yeah, she was saying that at the kickback, too. I was like, y'all got to get Fresh Prince out y'all mind.
But don't call it that.
It's not a comedy.
It didn't call it Fresh Prince, bitch. I called it Bel Air.
Yeah, it's called Bel Air. But
don't give me Will Carlton Hillary.
Yeah, right.
Fucking
it's
Ashley.
The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
If you think about what Carlton, the epitome of Carlton was, even back then, if you
he's
put it
just like this nigga,
minus the drugs,
yeah.
If you put it in a Carlton,
nigga sniffed coke, nigga.
No, he snorts Xanax.
That nigga sniffed coke. He a cokehead, nigga.
But if you think about it,
he might be gay.
If
the way these niggas doing shows now.
If the Fresh Prince was a drama back then, that would be Carlton. Carlton would be a snobby, I don't want you around here.
This is the dark side of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Basically. Like, Carlton lets his white friend say nigga and shit.
Yeah.
And everybody was like, that doesn't seem... That's what Carlton would be.
So
you gotta think, Carlton never experienced... Basically, they tell you Carlton never really experienced the hood.
Right, and he was with the niggas, the Gators... The Alamogaroos or whatever it was. Yeah. But Lisa though, is Lisa?
It's supposed to be Lisa, but you know, you never know if you're gonna get that far.
Right.
So I just gave you a Lisa because you're familiar with the name.
Right. And I told Vicky that, I was like, that's not the same Lisa.
It's just supposed to be homage to the name of a past character.
Okay,
but it's not.
Okay.
I think that's where they keep fucking up
Vicky
with people.
That. Yeah, I told Vicky that.
It's Lisa paying, it's homage, it's paying homage to Lisa by giving this girl the name Lisa.
One thing I do like is that they actually made Hillary smart.
I love that shit.
Oh, man. Yeah. Is she still a hoe?
No, but she fine, though.
She fine, motherfucker.
Chocolate
was
joint,
a freak on the
full figure, like,
on the low,
baddie.
Yeah, she was.
Wait, Hillary was bad back then, though.
I'm just saying, but she was like a freak.
Yeah, she was. Yeah, she was getting tossed.
Well, she was like, that is between me,
tossed.
That
and
man,
nigga
and
that
his
was
camera.
In my pool house. Yeah, right. That bitch getting tossed. But now this new Hillary is bad, too, though.
Okay.
I mean, and then what's crazy is Aunt Viv sound like Aunt Viv.
Mm-hmm. They picked a real good Aunt Viv. They did. They picked a real good
awesome
Aunt Viv.
Better than the second Aunt Viv?
Even his
yes,
mom,
definitely.
Though. His mom sound like his mom, though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and even my nigga Easy the Block Bleeder, whatever that nigga name is.
Easy the Block Captain.
Yeah, that's my nigga. Shout out to him. And nigga played a hell of a role in this shit.
Watch episode
my nigga Filet was
home.
In that hole.
Yeah, I'm definitely watching episode 4 when I get home.
My nigga Filet was in that
they
hole.
Had all, like,
so what's crazy is cause like in the comedy, he don't never get caught up by the nigga he had beef with. But mm-hmm. in this one here, it seemed like he might.
He ran into that boy.
When he went back, no.
But he was reformed.
Yeah.
He ain't gonna be reformed.
Yeah,
right.
This
nigga coming for Easy coming for him.
Right. What's crazy is Trey.
Yeah, Trey
is Trey. It's Trey Ice Trey from the comedy.
Yeah, Trey
that's
Ice
what I
Trey.
Thought.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I thought. I
so
good.
You remember his partner that came
yeah,
to visit earlier?
Yeah,
the
first
Don
Cheadle.
Yeah, Don Cheadle. So Don Cheadle's literally with him from the very first episode.
Right.
Like,
exactly.
Oh, okay. Like,
that's
like,
his nigga.
It starts.
That's his nigga.
Yeah. So that's his homeboy. That's the
who on the same team?
You know how many times I got jumped?
They the point in the two guard. The point in the two guard.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
when he in Philly.
Me and DJ. Yeah.
So this man's on fucking fire, bro. Like,
I'm gonna watch it.
No, I love it.
I just
bro.
Tell everybody, like, I get that you want to put it with the old school shit, but you gotta just let it go and watch this
just
as
watch
if
it
as
a new
brand
TV
new
show.
Right, and
that's
and,
hard
and,
to do. Though.
And as a sneaker,
it
nigga,
is. But I mean, when you tell me it's a drama, I leave all that comedy shit behind.
Right, and as a sneaker nigga, I like the way Will planted those Fresh Prince Fives.
Yeah,
and I see you, Will. Okay.
Will and Martin was gonna have on some J's, bro.
That's why I think they're gonna fuck up with if they ever do a Martin reboot because they want to keep it a comedy. You're gonna fuck up there,
right?
Because Martin was a comedy, and you're bringing back a comedy. So now they're gonna literally look at this shit like mirror images.
Yeah.
With this, I feel like when you made something a drama, you gave yourself that leeway to do whatever the fuck you want to do.
But who will be right in Martin's?
I don't think nobody would like anybody. I don't care who they pick.
But because this,
it keeps being rumored as DC.
Nah, he too Atlanta for and, that shit. But I mean, cut you off.
But they might move it to Atlanta.
But right now though, so Will was a comedy, right? I think this gentleman that they have right now is perfect for a drama. The only thing I don't like, I think his Philly accent is forced. He ain't gotta say John every time. I listen to this nigga. Like I'm not even from Philly and I say John every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
But I think my John's a little more authentic than that nigga's.
That and the fact that you can tell he studied Will.
Yeah.
And so, like, there was one of them times where they were in the foyer and he was crying. He started doing that little Will twitch.
Yeah, right, exactly.
That twitch he did. He's like, why he don't love me no more, man?
Right.
He started kind of hitting that twitch. I was like, see,
this scene
don't even need that.
Stop watching Fresh Prince, my nigga.
Yeah, stop. like, we don't need you to be Will Smith.
Right,
it's
exactly.
Quite fucking fine. Yeah. But other than that, I think
the casting was great, though.
Yeah, I do
Cassin
too.
Cassin is great.
I hope they start to show Ashley more because Ashley is almost like the youngest daughter in Power when Ghost was still alive.
Damn near obsolete, nigga.
Yeah, she's just like there.
Yeah,
it's a child. It's a child that you see walking in the background.
Right, she got little punchlines every now and then. Yeah,
she had the breakfast table.
Yeah, right.
She's just there.
Walking scenery.
She's just there.
I don't know. Maybe it's a sick nigga in my head, but I think Jeffrey gonna end up popping off Unveil. He's Jamaican. He's fit. Nigga dressed nice. He gonna fucking ain't Viv.
I hope not. That's good.
I don't know.
Hey, is Jeffrey on there?
Jamaican. He's Jamaican.
And I ain't seen that nigga clean out a motherfucking thing in that
he
house
clean
yet.
Shit. He's a house manager.
Yeah, there you go.
Who the fuck is a house manager?
Walking around with a stack.
You manage the other niggas? Hey, nigga say I got a date.
Hey, did you see that even like? But did they do a whole? This is why you almost can't fault some people who do
compare
because they pay a lot of homage to the original. Did you catch the basketball scene? You're not from Bel Air, are you? You're not from Malibu. You ain't from Bel Air either.
I said,
y'all didn't have to like mid game.
Yeah, right.
He talking because you remember when he threw the game because he saw his kid
from Jason Lee. Yeah, right.
So he dribbling at the top of the key.
Do you think he was gonna miss though and lose the game?
Nah, because they didn't add nothing else in there.
I thought he was gonna lose the game because of that shit because that's what the original was.
But they didn't show no kids or none of that, so I didn't think they was gonna play into none of that.
That nigga was like, you ain't from Malibu, huh? He was like, you ain't from Bel Air, and cross that nigga.
I'm gonna watch it.
In his eye.
you don't have to force all the homage. It's okay to just let that hoe be.
But when Carlton walked into that last game, I thought he was gonna fuck up the game.
I said, hey, nigga ain't on the team to grab the ball.
Yeah, I was like, how you gonna do this shit?
It's all good.
It was an episode.
Episode 4 just dropped today.
But it was a point to where Carlton was pissed off because everybody went to Will's game and then goes to his lacrosse game. So I kind of seen that too.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
We all saw that coming. Yeah, you saw that coming.
I definitely thought Carlton was going to tackle Will on that court.
Especially when they started coming back and Hilly was like, let's just stay.
Let's stay
a few more minutes. I said, they're not going to go to this nigga game. That's fucked up. They're not going to go to this nigga game.
He was getting his ass real paused on the fucking lacrosse field.
For real?
He was getting popped.
They gave you the right episodes, though. The first three was a good package.
It was great.
It was a good package.
I'm glad they gave you three off top to kind of reel you in. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That shit was fucking phenomenal.
You could tell that the nigga that's behind this hoe is a Philly fan and a battle rap fan
because
he had Easy starring in it. He had Freeway as Will's basketball
they had
coach.
What Freeza? You do is wrong on the first episode.
Yeah, he wake up to what you do is wrong.
His alarm is what we do is
say
wrong.
Less.
And then they had it's a battle rap analyst like the number one battle rap analyst was like Easy homeboy with the dreads.
Yeah,
that's Jay Black.
Oh shit. Okay.
So yeah, so it was like, okay. so he knew. You know they put the culture in that house. So yeah, it was dope. It was dope. I fucks with it. I'm tired. I'm strapped in. We good.
Okay.
They what else? We just had the Super Bowl. Fuck the game. I really don't care about the game. I ain't, my team wasn't
y'all
in it.
Shit, yeah, my team wasn't in it.
How'd y'all like the halftime show?
I thought it was cool.
I thought it was good.
Fat 50 was cool.
Fat 50, 75 Cent.
75 Cent was cool.
That nigga looked like
I'm with you, bro. Whoever fucking put that video of Snoop smoking
should be fired.
Should be fired, bro.
Yeah.
No, but that's Snoop though.
But still, they should be fired, bro. That's confidential information,
That's true.
I mean, you get a password because you're Snoop and you're in California where it's legal.
Yeah.
But technically you're showing behind the scenes shit. Like there's a reason he didn't do it openly.
Exactly.
He ducked down and hit it and then put it out.
The NFL wouldn't want that shit being shown. So
no, but shout out to all my Crip niggas. You know what I'm saying? Big season and so.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to cut you off. Go ahead.
That's three times, bro. Keep going.
My bad. I'm keeping the rhythm going.
No, I'm gonna cut you off. I thought it was dope. I don't know if anybody else paid attention, but I saw Dr. Dre and Snoop on stage, and I saw that mixing board. I'm like, bro, that looked like a real mixing console.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw Dre fucking with it. I was like, oh, this is definitely... Dre would not put this shit in somebody else's hands, bro.
Yeah, right.
That's why him and Snoop performed first.
Yeah.
And then that nigga went to mixing everybody else's sound.
Yeah,
bro.
Right.
Hey, fam. Genius.
But yeah, it was genius, bro. K-Dot had a live, his part was live.
Excellent, bro. Shit was excellent.
He didn't drop like I thought it was.
Nah, shit was excellent.
He should have maximized this time, bro. It would have been perfect. I wanted Mary to hit her dance, bro. That was the only thing I was mad about.
Yeah, I think everybody was waiting on that shit.
That's the only thing that I didn't see.
But rumor has it that she wasn't even going to perform because they didn't pay her.
No, nobody gets paid for the halftime show.
Nobody
gets paid. Like Grammys, none of that shit. You don't get paid.
I did not
know that. It's free promotion, bro.
Because your stream services are going to go up. Do you
know how many people watch the fucking Super Bowl?
Yeah. Oh, I already know.
Every song that was performed is...
Everybody's streaming services was over 100%.
Yeah.
Over 150%.
The year Katy Perry brought out Missy.
Yeah.
Missy had four albums hit the top three.
Damn.
No, top five.
Damn.
Because you got to think, little kids had never seen Missy. So they're like, damn, what's all this? Yeah, so they ran her albums back. So like she had like four albums in the top five, top ten, some shit.
I think that Super Bowl performance was fucking awesome. If you didn't like it, you just a fucking hater. Same shit I said Sunday, bro. That shit was great from top to bottom.
Yeah.
But I seen somebody post something about like, oh, about time they didn't have, like the old people was waiting for like Mick Jagger and like all that other shit. And then we get Dre and Snoop and they old, and then we realize we the old niggas now.
Yeah. But
you know what I'm saying?
The NFL had fucked us for a bunch of years, so long. Bro. Because of what Justin did, and they let that nigga come back and get a whole Super Bowl.
Titty?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We haven't had a black act headline the Super Bowl. That's not true. A hip hop act.
Is Jay still over the shit?
Beyonce did, but I mean it's Beyonce.
Yeah. Is Jay still over the shit?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
That's the only thing that nigga. Good,
if he take that shit to New Orleans, let Boosie ride.
Relax.
I know he a real nigga.
We're not gonna do that tonight.
He go to Buffalo.
We're not gonna do that
tonight.
We're not gonna do that tonight.
West Side go.
Super Bowl will never be in Buffalo.
A Griselda.
The Super Bowl will never be in Buffalo.
A Griselda.
It's 12 degrees in Buffalo.
A Griselda Super Bowl.
They're not having an outdoor Super Bowl.
I'm wearing a full face mask.
Where you can't see the fucking field.
I'm wearing a full face mask. Don't give a fuck.
You're gonna be freezing outside.
Nah, shit was great, man. I had a wonderful Super Bowl. I celebrated with my family. I celebrated with my friends. I celebrated eating whatever the fuck I wanted to eat.
Because
it's intermittent fasting shit. It's crazy.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie to you.
I didn't... I liked the Super Bowl. I ain't had no beeps with nothing because I understood how the game is supposed to be played.
And it was in Spanish.
That too. You know, it helps a little bit. Them niggas, like the people online who were like, this was PC, this was safe, this was blah blah blah, hating on it. It's like, dog, you delaying progress,
because
now they can say, see, y'all people didn't even like this shit.
Right.
It's like, relax, bro, take what you get. Like what the fuck you thought they was gonna do on national fucking TV? This was basic TV.
Yeah, basic
it's not
cable.
Even cable.
Yeah, basic TV. Yeah,
as long as you got an antenna, you get to watch this shit.
You get to watch the game. Yep.
So, like, fam, you got to deal with it. Like, when you say, when people get mad because they say, they made Kendrick take out the popo line and no Pyrus and Crips in the song. Well, duh, nigga. You're at the fucking, you're at a fucking billion, it's a $1 billion company.
In L.A.
In L.A.
That's my thing. Like, who else? I mean, who?
You got niggas Crip walking. So they recognize Crips. So Kendrick had to nix two lines out the song.
In full khakis.
Who cares?
Full khaki suits.
Locked up.
Kendrick took out two lines of a whole song. Y'all niggas angry, bro. Like, shut the fuck up, bro. And now, Kendrick happy to be there.
Now watch y'all silly niggas enjoy the fucking All-Star game in fucking Cleveland.
Cleveland, my nigga.
Who's performing at that, huh?
No, I don't know.
Who cares? It's Cleveland.
Born ass Cleveland.
It's Cleveland.
I'm just watching the dunk contest, nigga.
Cleveland Rocks. Machine Gun Kelly. Whatever.
They can bring out bone.
If they real.
Me killer.
Yeah.
Drug dealing, scandalous nigga.
I'm running that home.
So in tune with Super Bowl weekend. DaBaby whooped up Dane Lay's brother, and now that nigga is suing for getting his ass whooped.
He's a bitch.
He just set light skinned niggas back about 10 years, bro.
Hey, I'm sorry, DJ.
That hurt, bro. Yeah. Like, just take your ass whooping like a man,
no,
bro.
No, this wasn't no ass whooping. Nigga got jumped.
It don't matter.
No, he got jumped. He got jumped on a bowling.
Well,
alley,
I ain't
nigga.
Saying.
No, had grip.
I didn't say it was ass whooping, as in DaBaby whooped his ass one on one in the fair one.
Take your L
and go home, nigga. It's fine.
I mean, but if you looking at trying to make some quick, easy money.
That's all he was trying to do?
It's 2022. Niggas ain't really making money. Yeah, niggas it's 2022.
And
niggas gonna
probably,
sue.
You probably fucking my sister out some money, too.
Yeah, so niggas gonna sue.
He's trying to get his bag.
I'm hearing you for $1.2 million.
Bro, man, just take your L,
I mean, but why was he there anyway, though?
He's something like a celebrity because of his sister.
It's no fucking way.
Damn,
if she's barely a celebrity. Yeah, right. Nah,
Danny
Lay can get the business.
She can get the business, but she's barely a celebrity.
No, she's a celebrity. He's a celebrity by association.
If you fucking my sister and she's not there and you having a bowling party, why would I be there? Like, if we not even cool like that, though?
Yeah, they not fucking with each other, let alone that together.
So that nigga came for animosity, my nigga. So I would get that case tossed out and like, fuck you and your...
From the other views that were on cameras... Because they were actually filming shit. They were filming for, like, Revolt and MTV and some other shit. Yeah. They said there's camera... Like, he was walking up to have a conversation with DaBaby. But the last time DaBaby seen this nigga was on a line and you telling me it's on site. So I don't blame a nigga for swinging
on you. Right.
I don't know what you doing.
Right.
You walking up to me, and the last time I seen you, you said it was on site.
So it's on site. Yeah,
oh,
right.
Okay, well, then I ain't got no problem with
it. Case closed, then. Yeah.
Do y'all agree with it should have been a fair one, or do you agree with rich niggas don't have to throw hands?
It got to be a fair one. If you bold enough to be like, it's on site whenever or whatever, then yeah, it got to be a one-on-one.
I ain't gonna lie. If I hit a certain bracket with this podcast, I'm not touching niggas.
I'm not touching nobody, yeah.
I'm going to let Mathis handle niggas.
I was just about to say the same thing. If I was a multimillionaire and niggas all had, and all y'all niggas had jobs around me, I expect somebody to punch a nigga before I have to punch a nigga.
I already know who my dirt person gonna be.
I know who my shooter is. I know who my fighter is. Y'all staying with me at all times.
I already know who they are.
Yeah.
My nigga.
And
I'm Candace. I've talked.
And this was an event.
Yeah.
And this was an event. So he had them all with him.
This is true.
Y'all, they all were there.
Yeah.
The party goers, the fighters, the shooters, the security. Yeah.
The only time I was swinging at you to make me look good on social media. That's when I swing at you, like he did.
Even though that punch didn't connect, when you saw it on the other view, it didn't matter.
But that's fine. I swung at you.
I went for it first.
I let my niggas handle you.
I will add the bowling alley to the list
the
of places
place
I won't
fight.
The gym, the pool, and now the bowling alley.
Because if you fight on lanes, you slipping. If you fight on the other side of the lanes is too close to weapons.
You got a bowling alley coming towards your head, nigga.
Yeah,
I'm definitely about to hit you with a six ounce.
I'm definitely bowling a strike.
We're not doing that. We're good. We're not doing that shit.
I'm hitting you with
I'm
a 6 ounce.
I'm not fighting
ounce,
at the
nigga.
Gym. I'm not fighting on a balcony. And
definitely not fighting on the balcony.
I'm not. You punked me that day.
Right.
You punked me, you won that day.
You got a
fan. And I'm not fighting in the pool. Because I'm definitely not swinging. I'm trying to drown a motherfucker.
Is he good? He all right?
You know, he has a...
Yeah.
Yeah, she thinks so. Yeah, probably not. Yeah. they had the Harden and Ben Simmons trade to top off the NBA trade deadline.
You see Harden health is 100%, right?
That boy took that fat suit off.
Yeah.
He'll be back after the All-Star break.
In the words of G.
That boy step back is phenomenal.
After the All-Star break, he'll be back to playing. That nigga Tracy McGrady said, "Hey man, if you got a bad calf or bad hamstring, you ain't doing
step backs. You ain't doing step backs.
Square business.
You're not doing step backs with a bad hamstring. You're not doing step backs, my nigga."
I ain't never had a bad hammy, and I don't do step backs like that, so I wouldn't know, but I'm going to take T-Mac word for it.
That nigga is in practice doing step backs.
Because that nigga T-Mac said that shit with confidence. See, that nigga said ain't nothing wrong with that nigga. He doing step backs.
Shit, Barkley said the same thing. Barkley, when LeBron and KD was picking doing the teams, draft.
He said he'll be ready tomorrow.
Yeah, he'll be ready tomorrow. Oh, he's out of Brooklyn? Oh, yeah, he's good.
That shit was petty and amazing.
Yes, it was.
All at once.
Did you see the press conference?
No.
Harden's press conference?
Nuh-uh.
He wanted to go somewhere where people would do anything to win.
Wow.
Harden has what I like to call that poussey.
That
poussey. All y'all are mad at Harden. I don't get it.
Huh?
I don't get why y'all mad at Harden.
Because this nigga's forced his way out of two situations he's begged to be in.
No, I didn't want to go to Brooklyn.
He begged to go to Brooklyn.
No, he begged to go to fucking Philly. Get it right. Remember now, don't get a selective memory. He wanted to go where Dale Morey was the whole time.
He begged to go to Philly, but he settled for Brooklyn.
I never wanted to be in Brooklyn, but I got KD and Kyrie, so that's cool. Now, KD hurt all the time, and this nigga don't want to take a needle to the arm so he can fucking play in these basketball games.
You know what's funny?
You know what make it worse? Bitch, then you finally decide to come play, and we still losing the games that you came back in to play when we were away. It's pointless, nigga. Get me out of here, coach.
I'd have made that fat motherfucker stay there.
I'm gone.
Cooper Kupp and Matthew Stafford played more games.
I know Perk probably killed that nigga on Tuesday. I don't give a fuck. I'm with Harden.
They played 16 games together. Harden, KD, and Kyrie. 16 games.
I came here to be a part of
Cooper and Stafford played 17.
Yeah. I came here to be part of a trio, nigga. I'm out here playing by my motherfucking self.
Shout out to Cooper. Shout out to Cup though.
And then niggas
nice. Did,
for sure.
Yeah, no, bro. I'm one of the only niggas that's not mad at that nigga, bro. I'm not mad at that nigga, bro. Because like what he said, bro. If you don't want to play basketball, leave so we can use that money to fill the rest of this fucking team. This nigga is taking $30 million.
Talking about Kyrie.
And have you seen the supporting cast in Brooklyn? Mm-hmm. For this fight, last year was straight. This year
it's JV team, not even sophomore team.
Whatchamacallit?
This shit is ass.
I know if they meet in the playoffs, Philly taking their bitch ass to the crib.
Probably so. Okay, I gotta see how Ben Simmons look.
It don't matter how Ben Simmons look.
I mean, I still got more games to beat you.
That nigga still don't have to shoot. I don't give a fuck what nobody say.
If the mandate not lifted, I still like my chances to beat your ass. Because this motherfucker that y'all counting on still not playing in half of the playoff series.
I think that's going to change too. But the Brooklyn Nets got better defensively. They added to me the best defensive player in the league.
Pardon this interruption. Mm-hmm. If word to ESPN. If it changes, how long has your boy ever been healthy? Has he ever been healthy? Yeah. Like one season?
What happened in that one season?
Okay,
they won the motherfucking championship.
I'm just checking. All right, I hear you. I'm not mad at that nigga, bro.
I am. Fuck James Harden, bro.
If three of y'all motherfuckers stop coming every time we record, and some other motherfuckers with a popping podcast say, "Hey DJ, you can come record with us," I'm gonna leave you non-recording motherfuckers.
Oh, and then we dropping super diss track.
That's my nigga. I'm talking about you, your kids, and your wife.
I don't give a fuck, nigga. I came here to work, and if you don't want to work too, then fuck you, nigga.
That nigga fuck DJ Kyrie, going bro. From Army to social Kyrie's complex.
Kyrie is a selfish bitch ass nigga.
Why is Kyrie a selfish bitch ass?
Selfish bitch ass nigga. Because if you don't, because getting a shot is part of playing basketball in New York City. Either say trade me. Or quit playing basketball. Those are your two fucking... No, there's no hand raising. You got two options. If you really love basketball, you got two options. You get a needle in your arm or you get fucking traded. Simple as that. Or you quit so I can use this money to get a real fucking basketball team on this court.
You know what's funny? If he would have gotten traded, he would be able to play in Barclays.
That's why I said that's
a stupid fucking rule.
That's right.
That's a stupid fucking rule.
You don't make the rules. The rules are the fucking rules. I can't change that shit. I'm sorry you chose to go play in one of the biggest cities in the fucking world that has fucking mandates because motherfuckers don't know how to protect their fucking selves.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Right. Not my fault.
Right.
Yeah.
Damn, I mean, that's crazy.
Quick. I'm not. Request a trade or get a shot.
I'm with Curry, bro.
That's crazy.
Or be a bitch, and he chose to be a bitch.
Whoa, that's an aggressive.
If adjective. I'm, you know what I'm also mad at? I'm mad that Kevin Durant not mad.
Kevin Durant is mad.
I'm mad that he.
Oh, that he not mad at Kyrie?
Yes. You mad? You mad at me for not wanting to put up with your bullshit ass partner?
You know why? Because KD can carry that team, and James Harden.
He didn't do it last year.
He
had a better supporting cast.
He carried him. He carried him as far as he could go.
All right then, nigga. So they got the supporting cast is worse. So what is he gonna do now? Before the trade. Okay. It's nice because Seth balling the fuck
Seth,
out.
Seth is big hooping. Shout out to Duke.
Shout out to Duke.
When Ben Simmons gets back and he don't have to shoot, like I said, and Kyrie get all these open jumpers and Seth Curry gets open jumpers and we all know.
And I want this to be known. I'm not a James Harden fan.
Okay.
At all. I shitted on James Harden while he was on the Rockets. Repeatedly. Readily. I shitted on that nigga. Because he always comes up short.
And him and Joel going to get into it too. How are they going to play together? They've both never played with somebody like the opposite person.
Got you. I just don't want people to negate the fact that there's a bullshit nigga over there. There's a nigga in Brooklyn bullshitting. And people seem to just let that go because that's Kyrie. And that's just what Kyrie does.
Yeah.
You don't get a pass for being a bullshit nigga just because you're a bullshit nigga.
You make exceptions for exceptional
people. That's like, well, I'm about to have an example, but it does work for this nigga, so I can't even use it. I'm about to say that's like Brandon being an asshole just because everybody knows Brandon's an asshole. But Brandon literally does get to just
you
be
make
an asshole.
Exceptions.
I can't make Brandon jokes.
You make exceptions for exceptional people.
If you made a Brandon joke.
Oh, I'm getting slapped.
You're getting slapped.
In the face.
Brandon makes a Brandon joke and it's...
That's just Tubbs.
Stop playing, Tubbs. That's just that bullshit.
If I tell a girl I would love to suck your titty at the bar, I'm getting smacked in the face. And Tubbs is going to get laughed at and...
Might get a titty pulled out. Yeah.
What does Ben Simmons getting his way do? Because he got his way.
He definitely got his way.
Rejuvenation.
To the league.
Rejuvenation.
What you mean?
He can... This is... His second childhood. My nigga, nah.
Oh, yeah. For him, life is good. But I'm saying... Yeah.
What does it do for the league?
For owner-player relations.
Oh.
A nigga just said, I will never play for this team again and literally sat at home and said, I have mental health problems.
And then he was on the bench last night.
Chilling.
Iced out.
Prada.
That nigga was iced out.
Iced out.
Prada down. Nice chain. Cracking jokes.
I seen him in shoot around. Nigga was shooting threes in the shoot-around.
I already said, when that nigga get traded, he knocking down threes.
First shot. I'm pulling up from half court. I'm taking a logo three if I'm Ben Simmons.
All them threes, y'all seen that nigga shooting in pickup games? That nigga shooting them hoes. He shooting them hoes.
Ben Simmons. Y'all know where I stand about this anyway. I thought that the Philly handled it wrong. I thought that, if I was Philly.
Yeah, Doc fucked up.
If I was, and that's my other point. I don't give a fuck. You could put Kevin Durant on the fucking Sixers. Guess who's still fucking coaching?
Doc Rivers.
Doc Rivers.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Blow That Lead. You don't like that nigga.
Mr. Blow the Lead.
Blow the lead.
It's been three times where a team has been down 3-1 and they have lost their series. Guess who was the coach all three times?
Doc Rivers. Tragic.
Austin Rivers' daddy. You motherfucking right. This nigga traded his son-in-law. That nigga gonna light they ass up when they play. Seth Curry going off at 35. Watch. Ben Simmons don't have to do shit, bro. The nigga is 6'10", defend your center or your point guard, and he gonna... Imagine Kevin Durant getting an easy shot that he don't have to work for. Mm. The nigga already get 30 points off 12 shots.
Mm-hmm. I got Kevin Durant on one side, I got Seth on the other side.
Damn.
Yeah.
And think about it. Joe Harris got to come back. That's floor going to be spread the fuck out. Joe Harris, Kyrie, Patty Mills.
Kyrie every couple games.
Okay. Get the 5 seed and have a game 7 on the road. The fuck?
Trash. Do y'all ever think there'll be a world where they'll give kids their own social medias?
What you mean?
And stop intermingling them hoes?
Talk about like giving kids Instagram and TikTok?
Where it's just kids.
No.
It's
just
no.
kids?
Nah, no. That's way too pervy.
But I mean, you still have to, I would think, I mean, even as a parent, I would still monitor it to see what's being said and what's being sent. Like Jace has Twitch. I have that nigga's email in my phone. So anytime somebody sends him a message on Twitch,
you get it?
I see it. I see everything that's done on Twitch.
Oh, okay.
So I mean, that's the way I see it. But I keep seeing people saying they want like to I mean, I feel like you still have to monitor your kids' social media, but I think the fact that social media is just one big pool of everybody, I think that's just
leave it like that.
That's just weird. I don't like that. I don't think because with the way that they like to suggest things for you and they put things on your feed.
Yeah, right.
And then if you go to the explore page, it could be any fucking thing on that explore page.
Right.
Like there's no way to say that you're protecting anything from a child because no matter what settings you put on it, anything can always pop up on the timeline.
And then you still have like
curiosity.
People that's gonna figure their way through. Yeah. Like you can post a 8-year-old kid and make the date a 8-year-old kid. What verification do you have?
None.
That's gonna prove that this is an 8-year-old kid. You know what I'm saying?
That's true.
So yeah. So like yeah. I
perfect example. Jace has his own Instagram account, right? But it's on.
He does.
It's only on my phone. It's not. Okay. He doesn't have access to it outside of when he's around me.
Oh, okay.
You go to the explore page. You go to the search page right now. First thing you see. Chloe Haley, supermodels,
right,
muscle
right.
bitches, like
right.
muscle bitches.
There's no filter to it. I mean, like there's some kitty cartoon shit on here, but yeah. I gotta scroll to see it.
It's also some titties on there.
But it's supermodels and shit.
They got Alexis Kyle on that bitch.
So what out of what my son has liked, and I can see what he's liked as well, it's nothing but kitty shit. But somehow his explore page is still adult shit.
Yeah. And I don't know. My daughter don't have TikTok no more because the songs that they pick on TikTok is fucking out of there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So she's begging for TikTok back, but I'm just like, I don't know. Like I don't want to be that parent to kind of shelter you because I know when you get freedom, you out of there. And I know females with a little freedom turn to freaks.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're getting tossed.
I know.
No matter what high school college you go to. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, I tossed a couple in high school and college. You know what I'm saying? But you know, it is what it is though. But
long time.
And TikTok is the same way.
Long time ago.
You can have the most kid friendly ass feed, and then one day one thing pops up, and if you like it, your whole algorithm switches up.
Some hentai.
Yeah, I definitely have to figure out the algorithm shit because my YouTubers, no. My Instagram on my car shit was crazy.
Yeah.
I like one bitch with one bikini. That shit was filthy.
Yeah.
In my fucking magnifying glass tab. This shit was filth.
I was posting my car,
bro,
nigga.
I just got my Twitter right. That shit was filth.
Oh, my shit is.
There's no way I should pull up my Twitter account at 2:30 in the afternoon and see pussy.
Oh, that's times. It's 8 in the morning. No, it's before the sun comes up. It's before the sun comes up, lunchtime, and it's all zip code. I mean, it's time zone related. So in that 3-hour window of lunchtime.
Really?
And then it's get off work time.
Cause I'm like, dumb. It's literally 2:30. I'm trying to enjoy the Subway sandwich and I see pussy.
So you got like that 12 to like 2-3 range?
I'm not tripping.
You got that 12 to 2-3 range because it's lunchtime from coast to coast.
Yeah. Right.
And then you got like 4 to 7 from get off time from coast to coast.
I'm not tripping.
So it's pussy.
But if I'm demoing the phone, my customer don't want to see
pussy.
Pussy. And my sub. What the fuck? Damn, I'm hungry as shit, bro. Like I ain't gonna lie to you. Fuck this internet.
I'm on my fucking Richmond College. It's filthy, man.
My Twitter is disgusting. My shit. I had to follow other shit just to get my that shit.
Luckily, I follow a lot of battle rap shit. So like when they get into it, it would take up my feed, and then my Clubhouse crew niggas of music heads,
and they gonna retweet that shit. Yeah,
some chick was like, I followed you, and I went through your follow list. I'm like, why would you do that?
Yeah.
I was like, it's disgusting, ain't it? She was like, yeah. she's like, yeah, it's pretty bad. I was like, did you follow anybody? She's like, yeah. Yeah, there you go.
And then all it takes is that one account, and then that one account will be like liking all their homegirl shit.
Yeah, I'm like, there you go.
That one nasty ass account just put all this other nasty shit on your fucking
page.
It'd be like,
you might like, and I
bro, that shit. I just
you don't know
my shit,
life,
bro.
Nigga.
Yeah,
you don't know.
I mean,
me.
I like you, but goddamn, nigga, I don't want to see it.
I don't like it because they put you on blast when you hit that heart button, and then they be on somebody else's feed.
It'd be like
so and so like this.
My nigga, so
shout out to Corey Moe.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. When I see Corey like this shit, and I was like, man, you know what? Ain't nobody following me on this shit.
That's the same thing I'll be thinking, like, too. I'll be like, fuck.
I like this hoe too, bro. Fuck it. And then every now and then I hear DJ in the back of my head. I trying to live through Corey. you can live through Tubbs too.
Anytime I see like a bitch on my timeline, she could be clothed, but it's still sexy.
It's a Mary Champa Bay.
I'll be like, duh.
I ain't gonna lie.
My nigga in the clutch again.
My nigga, I ain't gonna lie. I follow about 60 shit. Bitches from Corey. Like by Mary Champa Bay.
Especially today at work, I was just slow boogie, bro. So I was just.
Yeah, just like, bro, and it's crazy because they be like the baddest bitches. I be like, man, I would like to see that again. Let me follow this up, bro. Fuck it.
That shit crazy.
Oh, man.
They know too much about us, bro.
Did y'all niggas catch that Cosby thing?
No, I haven't. I heard.
Bro, y'all niggas gotta watch it, bro.
Filthy.
Just watch it, bro. Just watch it. It's crazy.
I'm not behind on some of this shit, bro.
Like this nigga Bill Cosby is a monster, dog.
Well, duh, nigga.
I didn't think so.
They've been trying to tell you for a decade.
I didn't think so, bro. That nigga Cosby is filthy, nigga.
And then it's bad because like the stuff I've seen from the documentary, it's bad shit.
Yeah.
But you know, you can always make something look way better or way worse.
Cosby is filthy,
like the episode where he was talking about his barbecue sauce.
Yeah.
Nigga scared the
they
shit
like,
out of me.
They like slowed it down and shit. And I'm like, bro, this looks way creepier than
that. That nigga was talking to what's his wife? She got the wife name on the show?
Claire.
About that barbecue sauce?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. They slowed it down. And I'm like,
oh my
shit.
God. Bro, this nigga was a Spanish fly connoisseur. Even on Larry King, he was like, yeah, I dropped a little bit. I was like, dog, this nigga was drugging bitches, just drugging bitches. But it was only one instance where I feel that bitch was lying because her story was different from everybody else.
Who, the supermodel chick?
No. It was like the one of the first couple of joints. Like, she was like, I remember this. But everybody else was like, I remember this, went blank, and then I remember this, and I apologized because I felt like it was just me, it was on me, I was drunk, blah, blah, blah. And then he contacted me. Another joint was like, yeah, I was this, I was good, drink
I'm
that.
I'm not watching this then, shit, dog. This
no, but it was
a
like,
sicko, bro.
Definitely a sicko, but it was like.
That's why R. Kelly just got that nigga legal team. Somebody watched that doc and was like, hey, that nigga can beat this.
So what's crazy, because like they painted, I mean, because Bill Cosby, I'm not defending that nigga, but Bill Cosby was a good individual. That nigga did good for the community.
He's like to take pussy sometimes.
Yeah. Early on in the black community, he did look out early on.
True.
But then he used to, at the same time, drug bitches to get some pussy. Maybe he like pussy that just lays there.
Non-responsive.
He like starfish pussy?
Yeah, he like dead pussy.
Starfish
maybe,
pussy?
But necrophilia. He like dead pussy. That's cool. That's that man.
No,
it's
not.
That's that man
that's
issue.
Not cool. That's not cool. Okay. Watch your words. It's
my,
not
my
cool.
My fault. I mean, on his behalf, I don't give a fuck. I like my pussy to be active. Like I need
a reaction.
Yeah, right. I need you.
Talk back to me, man.
Yeah, bitch. I need you to move with me because you know. Thank you. Because this blue tree only gonna go so far. So yeah. So I like. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, like my nigga.
Big perv.
I forgot where I was going with this shit.
It's all good.
Anyways.
Big time perv.
Anyway, this nigga here. Anyway, but this nigga wild. Bill is wild. He is totally. And yeah, that's it.
It's bad that somebody who did such great things for black people.
Thank you.
Did the fucked up shit
and
to women.
And they put on the black stuntman. Yeah, yeah. I thought it. Hey, nigga.
It's some nigga bitches in there.
My nigga.
Not nigga bitches. Yeah, some right. Black.
Right.
Hey, black
let's
women.
Let's not put that on him, too.
We all in 42 minutes and they might not stay. Hey, it's all good.
Hey, on some real shit, though, when it was all white women, I was like, oh, he just fucking white bitches? Cool. Fuck the bitches.
Then you saw some color.
But then, yeah, it was some color that twinkled into. I was like, damn, Bill.
He did to
really?
Our sisters.
But everybody kept saying, we never seen Camille. Where is Camille? I met Camille one time. I've never seen Camille. She might have came to the studio once. Camille was out there getting her dick. Well, not getting her dick, but she was out there getting some dick. Because she was never around when the shit was going on. Either she was never around or she knew and didn't give a fuck.
That sounds fishy, too.
That second part sound about right.
That sounds fishy, too.
You know what I'm saying? Because, like, everybody's like, oh, yeah.
Camille's wife, right?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
For many years, and she's not ugly. She's bad.
You got to think about this, bro. Life in
celebrity
lifestyles are completely different.
I guess so.
Because the pool is so small. Because you just can't fuck with regular people, right? And then when you start fucking with regular people, and there's only so many celebrities that you could really fuck with.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to keep shit on the wraps because now you got an image. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it sound good to fuck that, but it's a little different, bro.
Let me say this. All right, the voice y'all hear is real.
What's good, everybody?
Yeah. All right, that nigga Rob Gillette did us like Rick Ross did 85 South. he said he had to step out and nigga never came back. But shout out to Gillette, though. That's my nigga. All right, let's go.
Did y'all niggas see the Tinder swindler?
Yes, I did.
No, I haven't.
That nigga
deserves to be a free man.
He does.
You talking about the nigga who was swindling them bitches for bread?
Yeah.
Yes.
And got out.
The boy was just jugging. That's all it sounds like.
It's a jug. It's a jug.
Yeah, okay. He about to get a dating show.
You take the L then.
That nigga about to get a podcast about how to make money. He's about to get a dating show on how to date bitches with money. That nigga, the Tinder swindler, is a friend of mine.
That boy just sound like...
I told one of my homegirls was like, he should be in jail. I said, if he should be in jail, then a lot of motherfuckers should be in jail.
Half these IG hoes.
Because I think almost everybody done lied to get some free shit.
It was your homegirl that said that?
Yeah.
How many dates she went on for a free meal?
Plenty.
Clink, clink, lock her ass up. If you got a count, nigga, it's too many.
But what's crazy?
I'm just trying to think, what's crazy?
That nigga name was not tied to none of these hoes took loans out in their own fucking name.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So that's not fraud.
No, nah. You gave me a gift.
It's a gift. It's a loan. If I don't pay you back that loan, that's not my fault. That's on you.
A sucker is born every day.
My exact words was: is it fucked up? Yes. Mm-hmm. Should he go to jail?
Mm-mm.
No. And then they got people on GoFundMe paying these hoes back.
Yeah. These hoes started a GoFundMe,
that hoe's already at like six, like it's over $6,000.
Right.
Because I know a girl was selling all that nigga shit.
And she got money.
She's still selling that nigga shit.
She's the smartest one.
Yeah.
That bitch was on the show was like, oh, I got a ping. Yeah, somebody want to buy this shit from this nigga.
Right.
That nigga was pissed off.
As she was getting interviewed.
But see, what's crazy is, though, as she's doing that, that nigga's here making money off on the side. He went to Israeli prison for 15 months. Got out after 5.
Shit, still.
And then went to jail for something else and didn't serve the full term. Like, that nigga's a free man. Yeah. Like, he just got an agent not too long ago.
I know what wouldn't have happened if he was a nigga.
If he was Nigerian.
Yeah.
Oh, they do that shit every day.
Bro, I've been, like, addicted to these fucking scammer YouTube videos.
Oh, man.
Nigga, that shit's crack. Like, hackers will hack into like scammer call centers and fuck with them. Like, they'll hack into their camera. They'll tell these niggas what they got on while they trying to scam you on the phone and shit. Like, look that shit up. That shit funny as fuck.
Oh, yeah, I'm about to go laugh at that
shit. I ain't gonna lie, my nigga.
I'm about to go home and laugh at that shit.
Nigga, I'm talking about like...
I got a story for you.
Niggas on that hoe shook, bro.
I got a story for you. We in the crib, right? I'm in the game room playing Madden. Playing Madden. I hear my wife, she goes, well, I mean, we get paid this weekend, so what happens with that?
Oh, no.
And, I mean, so what's going to happen with this? So you just going to close the account? So I'm listening, but I'm playing Madden. I'm like, she's doing something. Mm-mm. Playing Madden, right? I get up. I go to the kitchen to go get a beverage. She was like, well, yeah, my husband get paid this weekend. And I mean, I get paid Wednesday. So what's going to happen to the account? Like, you just going to close it or what's going on? So I'm like, well, who are you talking to? She was like, no. When I walked up, she was like, guess what happened? Somebody done took my social and got a Airbnb and rented a car, and they got caught with drugs in the car. I was like,
oh, hell no. That's the biggest scam. That's the biggest fucking scam. She almost fell for that shit.
No.
Yeah.
Let me finish. She did. I was like, what? She was like, yeah, I'm on the phone with the Social Security office. They about to cancel my social.
The drugs is what tipped it off. Yeah.
She was like, they about to cancel my social security number. I was like, you dead? She was like, no. I was like, can't nobody cancel your fucking Social Security number if you're not dead? Like, that's the only way you get your shit canceled. She was like, well, they're on the phone telling me that they just found somebody with some drugs and they're about to cancel my social. I was like,
What Indian person from the Social Security office is going to call you?
My nigga, I took the phone out of hand. I was like, hey, who is this? He was like, yeah, sir, we are calling your wife because we found somebody with some drugs and they rented a house and rented a car and it's in her name and her social about the accounts. I was like, hey, man, get the fuck off my phone. Like, this is fake. I already know it's fake. Yeah. I know about the deal. So get the fuck off my phone. Yeah. Sir, we don't want to talk to you. Put your wife on the phone. I was like, well, fuck you too. I don't want to talk to you either. Stop calling my fucking wife. Get the fuck out the phone. Hung up the phone, right? She was like,
I know you really didn't hang up like that, but I miss being able to hang up on people
right,
like that.
I didn't hang up like that.
Or like the flip phone where you just close that
door. Right. I hung up. She was like, well, why did you hang up? I was like, that's a scam.
Yeah.
I was like, first thing I said, did you give them any information about the bank account? She was like, no. All I said was, we about to get paid.
Yeah.
What's going to happen to the bank account when you close it out?
Yeah.
She was like, all I said was, what's going to happen to my social? Do I need another one?
Yeah.
And I was like, did you give them your social, your address? She was like, no, I didn't give them any of that.
Yeah.
So I caught that shit at the right fucking time because she was about to give up
all your shit up. Both of y'all.
Nigga.
Gift card scam. She was going to be at Walmart getting gift cards and shit.
So she was like, yeah, he said I had to go to CVS and get some type of card to pay them in order to not get her social taken away.
These niggas
I was like, are you not fucking thinking? Yeah.
These niggas will stay on the phone with you while you go to CVS and ask you step by step what's going on. Then they'll they got so crazy. You know how like, you know, you can mirror somebody's computer?
Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm.
They can mirror your phone now.
Yes.
So like you shouldn't even like pick them phones up. Like
you shouldn't.
So like when your mobile provider gives you a little message that says potential spam or you know whatever, don't answer that shit.
Hell no.
Wait until they leave a voice message and then call their ass back.
If it's anything that comes to your phone to ask you for like account access or an IP address or anything like that.
I done had like regular phone numbers call me. Yes, we need to verify
No, I'm good.
Your address?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah.
Could you tell us your address? No.
For
no,
what?
Yeah.
Or even if it's like a bill collector or some shit, like they'll be like, oh, this is a collection call, right?
Yeah.
And they're like, I need you to verify my address. No.
Yeah.
You should know where the fuck
nigga,
I'm at.
I've seen people have their phones, like their number call their phone.
Yeah.
Like you got a phone? It's what? Your number calling yourself. Yeah, right.
Damn. Mm-hmm.
Nah, that's
that
bullshit.
Because they trying to mask that shit. And it pissed me off because I got so pissed at her. I was like, are you not fucking paying attention?
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Because are you not seeing what's going on? You literally about to fall into this fucking trap.
And then just think about all the commission
like
he got.
You would have got a call from the cop before you got a call from Social Security.
Have you ever thought for them to erase your Social Security number? You would have to fucking die. She was like, Well, I didn't think about it. Oh, why are you not fucking thinking?
Because they put that fear. All right, so I want you to listen to this shit.
It was fear.
It was a fear tactic. I want y'all to go and watch that shit. It's two dudes. It's like this European dude. He might be Australian or something. He got a heavy-ass accent. He sound like a scammer his damn self. And then this is an American dude. And you just got to search the scam shit. I'll probably put it in the group text or something when I find it. Y'all got to check that shit out, bro.
Cause this nigga going to be up till 2 in the morning watching and laughing at shit.
Bro, this shit is fucking crazy because I'm like, what if I wasn't at home? Because
they typically go after like old ass women, and you're right. They typically go after like old women or older, you know, like elderly people who like don't make use of technology and shit. They still using Windows XP and shit.
I'm sorry. Say it one more time.
Old women and old people.
Say it one more time.
Old women and old people.
Okay. One more time. For
She's me. Not old. She's not old at all.
Look, I got mad at my wife the other day because we on the phone and she at the gas station. And she was like, babe, what's the pin? I said, where you at? She said, the gas station. I said, you at the pump? She said, yeah. I said, why the fuck you ain't do credit?
Bypass that shit. Yeah.
She said, what you mean? I said, girl, don't ever, 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 ever put a pin number in a gas station pump.
That happened one time, my nigga.
What? I said, fam, just listen to me right now. I'll explain it to you later. Like, I ain't got time to explain this shit right now. You're making me aggravated that you don't even know this shit.
Right.
Like, bruh. And then you get them shits like every month I get your Norton subscription is expiring. Please enter your card information. Nigga, ain't nobody used Norton since
the nigga who owned the commercial got his fucking identity stolen.
You know what's the biggest one?
What?
Them fucking Amazon scams, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They get people. No, I'm talking about they get everybody on that shit. You ain't got to be old at all. Bro, they damn near got me with that shit.
No, bro, I look at like, oh, you got this Amazon package that's blah blah blah. I look at what the address is. That's not my Amazon address. I always look at that, bro, because it's like I work in the industry where a lot of niggas are getting hijacked.
Right.
I had this one customer come in. She was like, yeah, somebody called me from you guys' company saying that they need to do this, this, and this, and that they need the IP address from the computer. I was like, please, ma'am, tell me you did not give them the IP address.
I think she told us this story before.
Yeah, she was like, yes, I did. I was like, ma'am, so what happened? She was like, yeah, so they basically cleaned out my whole account. I was like,
yep.
I
can do that. Yeah, you told us this story before. I remember that shit. I felt so bad for that lady.
She's literally like 60 something.
That shit crazy.
You know she's on fixed income, and I really want to talk bad
about all the idiots our age that get caught with the
Cash App scam
on social media, bro, and Facebook. Facebook and IG.
Is the camera on?
Yes, it's on.
If any of you motherfuckers, you know what? It ain't even y'all. If I block y'all, it's because I got a Cash App request from y'all on IG.
Exactly.
That basically mean they already. They fell for it before you did.
They already got hacked, yeah.
No, that's what that is.
No, I'm so in fear. Like, I feel like if I respond, I'm getting hacked.
I blocked Kirk Corona.
Oh, I definitely blocked the shit out of Kirk.
Because I thought he did it, but he got.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bro, I had a homegirl.
I feel like at this point, if you got.
You deserve to be blocked.
You got blocked.
I had a homegirl, not even famous. She's not nowhere, no celebrity, nothing like that.
Yeah.
She hit me up. She was like, hey, you know what I'm saying? What's going on? Blah, blah. Regular conversation. Chicken New York.
Yeah.
She was like, hey, man, something happened. I just need to borrow $200 real quick. I promise you, I got you back.
Mm.
And I was like, okay. And I was like, well, you know, let me think about it. I got to run shit past, you know what I'm saying, my wife, blah, blah, blah. She was like, all right, cool. Later on, she was like, hey, so can you help me out or what? And I was like, man, I could probably be able to help you out. Just give me a second.
Yeah.
Still literally, because I don't send shit through internet, bro.
Right,
like, you got to be a person for me to hit. Like,
yeah.
So I call the actual person who the IG was coming from. I was like, hey, CeCe. Damn. I was like, hey, yo. You need some money? He was like, nah, I'm straight. I was like, well, my nigga, you just hit me on IG, was like, you need 200.
I got hacked.
Yeah, she was like, nah, nigga, I got hacked. Like, she was like, 200? I was like, yeah, 200, I got you. She was like, nah, nigga, I got hacked. So later on, she was like, hey, this ain't me, bro, but I got hacked. My nigga, if I would have lost that $200.
Right, mad as shit.
Pissed.
I played along one time just to see what the process was.
I wanted,
I had to. Oh, me too.
Because I wanted to know what the process is.
Nope. And, 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 I, not,
No, you cool. You cool if you respond. Don't give them your shit though.
I let them go through with it. And the dude, it was like they basically send you a link to reset your
login and password.
Yeah, reset your login and password. And if you click on it, it then also goes to them.
Mm.
So then, but before you can even get in there and reset it,
cash out.
Yeah.
No, add they reset it.
That's what I'm saying. They can add funds and cash out on your shit.
They're not trying to get into your Cash App. They want your account because they figure this request coming from, like, me requesting it from you is easier, is more likely to get some money out of you than for a regular random person to get money out of you.
Basically, what you're saying is I'll get a hold of your account, mm-hmm. and then you send a request.
Be like, hey, DJ, my homeboy taught me. Be like, hey, really, my partner taught me how to turn 50 into 500 out of Cash App.
Nah, my nigga.
It sounds more.
I'm not even thinking on that aspect. I'm thinking like, you send a request to Corey since that's your bro. Corey will automatically off rip just be like, boom, I got you.
Or something like that. Yeah, but that's basically how it goes.
Nah, no, on that flip shit. Nah.
This car IG page is wild.
Yeah.
Cause like, my shit be getting hella Cash App. Like,
requests.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Nigga, my
unfollowed people requests is ridiculous.
Send me this, blah, blah, blah. Or like, hey, would you like to be sponsored by this and this and this? I'm like, all right, cool.
You remember Ashley Pickens?
I just recently got some shit from her, nigga.
Blocked?
Yeah.
Blocked the shit out of Ashley.
I called Ashley. I was like, Ashley, as soon as you requested that shit, I blocked your ass. She was like, what are you talking about?
Uh-huh.
She realized she got hacked.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, nigga, you hacked. A lot of folks don't realize it.
To somebody hit him and be like,
because
I don't even know her like that, but I knew, I saw it, I was like,
my nigga, my parents on Facebook,
yeah.
Whenever I see it, because first off, is them niggas old.
Yeah.
So you got to figure out, all right, are you old or did you get hacked? So when I see a new request from my pops, I'm like, hey, you did this? He was like, yeah, I did it. He did one time where it wasn't him.
Yeah.
It was a regular request. I was like, well, I'm not going to accept that shit.
Right.
Like, when my mom, she was like, no, I didn't do that shit.
Yeah.
So it's not her, because like, with old niggas, you gotta be like, nigga, this is you.
I'd be like my granny, nigga. That ass on Facebook. She out of there. She cannot send me shit because somebody got into her shit.
Yeah, I'm like, nigga, is it you or is somebody that's in your shit? Yeah, cause like old niggas don't pay attention to that shit.
I get
all kind of like they be trying to get me through my email. It'd be like stupid shit. Like I said, that Norton shit expiring. Yeah. It'd be that stupid Amazon package shit.
I get Amazon shit like twice a day, bro.
You won a sweepstakes. We just need your information to send the money to you. Oh, okay.
I ain't gonna lie. Niggas almost had me for a timeshare, though. I ain't gonna fucking lie.
I have a super common name.
Yeah.
First name, last name.
Yeah.
I get a lot of bullshit. Yes, bro. I've had my identity stolen.
Word.
Yeah. I didn't know it until I went to go get a car. Me and my pops went. And the dude, you know, he was, you know, joking with us while the whole process. He ran my credit. He came back in. He was like, well, at least you pay your child support. He giggled. Me and my dad laughed. He was like, that's all you pay is your child support. I said, what? My dad, look. I said, bro, I ain't got no kids, nigga.
Yeah, right. Like, yeah, right.
He was
right.
Like, man, he was like, it's on your report. I had a house in Florida, a repo car in Florida, unpaid child support.
In Florida?
Some of the stuff was in Florida. Some of the stuff was in Texas.
Florida man, gotcha.
Florida man got me, bro.
Florida man,
the house was from like 1995. I'm like, nigga, I was 9 years old. There's no way
anybody ever.
But I also tried to look and see if I had some unclaimed shit in
Florida. Yeah, right.
That part.
Yeah, right.
Anybody ever try to hit y'all with the lottery shit?
Nah,
I never got the lottery shit.
Man, I keep getting these text messages. My name is such and such and so and so. I just won the lottery. I'm trying to invest in people. And they'll send
I guess you're on Facebook. Yeah.
They send that shit to my phone. I get text that shit. Yeah, bro.
I guess you're on Facebook. Yeah, hey, you know, I just came across 17 million. I want to bless everybody on my timeline with $500 or something like that. Yeah, nah. You got to be a deafy motherfucker.
I know. I got that. I ain't blessing shit.
You
got
to be a deaf. Hey, nigga, fuck y'all.
Trust
niggas.
Me. If I hit the lotto and I tell you, and I'm texting people.
Hey, nigga, we get our own building, nigga.
I hit the lotto, a lot of niggas gonna lose my fucking number.
I'm texting dead niggas. Ass.
Y'all ever really? Yeah, I did. I don't know.
Smart man. Yeah, nah. Keep it quiet, because, man, niggas gonna pop up on
If I send you a text to say, walk out your job. Yeah. Walk out your job, nigga. We
nah,
fucking
I ain't
good.
Even gonna send you a text to tell you walk out your job.
Meet me at Sugarland Airport in 2 hours.
Not even. Not even, because we'll I'm be handling back. Business first. You gonna meet me at the new spot that's ours, nigga. Fuck you talking about?
With a bartender in the back.
Nah, I ain't paying no nigga to whip drinks.
We going on a trip.
No, I'm talking about at the studio?
Yes.
No.
You pour your own fucking drink, you lazy bastard.
Nigga, my studio would have a bartender, nigga.
Well, luckily it's not your studio. That's not. That's a waste of money. You know how much money that's going to cost you?
Well, you just got
a bartender?
Yes, nigga, that's a bad investment, especially at a studio. Just to be there? That's stupid.
For a bartender?
Yeah, we're going to talk off air, nigga.
Nigga, a bartender can work $25 for 2 hours, nigga.
We had 2 hours. So like that, we'll be right the fuck back.
Nigga,